Hey guys, welcome back to Commander Versus Series. Justin Parnell, Stephen Green, Jeremy Noel, Wes Wise, back for Season 4, Episode 3. So today we, as is usual for around this time, we're going to be exploring the newest and a very exciting set for Magic and Commander specifically, Eldritch Moon. Now, something that we did going into this, actually, Jeremy, you put up a poll on Reddit.
Yes, I contacted the mods over at the Reddit r/EDH, which is the Commander subreddit, and said, hey, I want to do this poll where we get the community involved. And so I put a straw poll up where we had all seven of the legendary creatures as options, and people could pick however many they wanted, and...
Just vote.
Yeah, just vote. And we had over 5,500 votes. By the time we ended it.
By the time it ended, and you guys kept voting afterward just to show your appreciation, and it got, like, it's approaching, like, 10,000 just because, I mean, obviously, you don't know that we're filming this right now, so you're continuing to vote, but we played the four highest vote-getting legends from Eldritch Moon, which were Emrakul, Gisa and Geralf, Ulrich, and Ishkanah. Now, some of you might be upset. You might be upset that we don't have any white creatures here because the three creatures that were not in the top four were all white creatures. Now, Thalia, that's fine. Thalia is just like, that card is, it's a little annoying. It's probably going to get you, like, off pretty quickly in Commander because it's not, like, a friendly card. But some of you are going to be upset that we're not playing Bruna or Gisela. And the only people you have to blame for not seeing the meld cards in Commander Versus today is you guys, because you couldn't meld together your votes to pick one. You split the ticket, and that's why we're not playing any of them.
I
went back and looked. Yeah. If they had combined their votes for Bruna and Gisela, Brusella as one would have been the third highest vote getter.
Yeah,
it would have been third. Instead, Bruno was fifth, Gisela was sixth, and sorry, blame yourself. Sorry, Bruno and Gisela fans, your fault. So, but we do have some sweet ones, and in my opinion, I actually think that Eldritch Moon is a fantastic set for Commander, just like Shadows was. But I really like the like five of the generals. I'm not like huge on Gisela or Thalia as generals, but specifically three of the ones we're playing, and then Bruna are great. Steven, why don't you start us off since you're playing the deck that I would want to be playing? But I mess around with Z Ord last week.
Gisa and Geralf.
Yes,
I'm playing zombies. And we're gonna raise the dead over here. That's what we're gonna do. So Gisa and Geralf enter the battlefield and I mill the top four cards of my library.
Okay. Always pretty good.
Yeah, and then it says during each of my turns I may cast a zombie creature card from my graveyard. It's pretty good. Yep. Gray Merchant every turn could be quite powerful.
Yeah, it could.
Oh jeez.
So basically today I'll have just new cards that I chose to play. So we got Liliana the Last Hope. I don't think I really need to explain why this one's good.
No. By the time you guys see this, it could have already taken over Standard.
Yeah, it's just good. But I got Graph Harvest. I'm really a huge fan of this card.
So what does that card do?
It's one black enchantment. It says zombies you control have menace.
It's priced right.
And for the low cost of four mana, you can exile a creature card from your graveyard and put a 2/2 zombie creature token onto the battlefield.
Oh, how delightful.
You don't have to tap it or anything.
So nothing.
You just four mana.
And then we have going to be a Standard All-Star. Crypt Breaker.
Man, I played against that card at the pre-release.
And you got
it. Did it break you?
Yes, it did.
It is a one mana
physically
1/1.
Physically and my spirit.
For the low cost of two mana, you can tap it and discard a card. Not a creature card, just a card.
Anything.
And put a 2/2 black zombie into play.
That must be all
it does. What else does it do?
Now, the real good ability is tap three untapped zombies you control. And you draw a card and lose a life.
Well, you don't have... So you can die.
I could kill myself. I don't think I will.
No, but someone else could kill you.
That's true.
Yeah.
Ooh.
And then we have the six-mana zombie.
I like how you're thinking.
The six-mana zombie from the set, which is Noosegraph Mob. comes into play with 501 counters on it. It says whenever a player casts a spell, you don't. It's not a may. Remove a 1/1 counter from Nuskraf mob. If you do, put a 2/2 zombie into play. So basically, if it stayed in play the whole time, you'd get 10 power out of 6 mana.
Yep.
Which is kind of Grave Titan, but not nearly as good.
Well, it's not nearly as good because obviously Grave Titan keeps doing this thing over and over again. But one, it is a zombie itself, which Grave Titan is not. It's true. Two, it has zero power, and a lot of things care about power being small.
Yes.
So this is an easy way to get this out of the graveyard with a bunch of stuff. Yeah.
And then, last but not least, we have Dark Salvation, which is one black XX. Target player puts X 2/2 black zombie creature tokens into the battlefield. And this is target player, so I can choose you. I'm not going to. I'm going to choose me.
You might be choosing me.
Up to one target creature gets -1/-1 until end of turn for each zombie that player controls. So it is a creature. It's like a token generator / removal spell for double X.
It's all. You know what else it is? A playmat.
It is a playmat.
It is a playmat. It is true.
The art is
Where
super sweet.
Where can you get that playmat?
You can get that playmat on the SCG Tour in our standard opens and or classics. Standard classics. Yep. And the art's awesome.
Yes.
I normally don't like shill for stuff. But I really, really do love that art. I love zombies and Liliana.
I've also got some other new cards in the deck, but these are the ones I wanted to focus on. So
is that a Cynthia Shepherd?
It is.
So how many zombies would it take to kill Emrakul?
I don't know. I can't even see the Emrakul because
how many zombies would it take to kill Steven if you had a Mindslaver?
Well, that's convenient because I have a lot of ways to get Mindslaver. It looks like there's only two. Emrakul, who does the Mindslavering herself, and then Mindslaver, who just does the Mindslaver
thing. You know what the bonus is? There's no Academy Ruins in your deck.
Oh, there's not, but there is Arcbound Reclaimer.
It wasn't done. There's also no Goblin Welders in your deck.
That's okay. Steven, do you think you're going to be safe just because I don't have, like, Trixie artifact things
First
that
off,
cost colored mana?
I just want you to know I have the Last Hope right here.
It's going to be the Last Hope by the time I take control of your turn.
She very much is. Look at her. Come at me,
bring
bro.
It. Yeah. Come on, bring it. Look, so my plan is to make sure that I can take, like, everyone's turn. Now, even though I only have these two things, I have a lot of ways to facilitate this and make a lot of mana to get back Mindslaver.
I bet you have a Kadalfa Forgemaster in your deck.
I actually don't have a Kadalfa Forgemaster.
It sounds like you don't want us to have fun tonight. That's what it sounds like.
As my friend Glenn Jen likes to say, there's a finite amount of fun to be had in any match of Magic, and I want to have all of it.
I want to have all of it. Yep.
So the only other new card I'm playing from Eldritch Moon is Soul Separator, which I think you also have in your deck.
Oh, I'm definitely put zombies into play.
Put zombies into play, but this is pretty sweet. So with, like, Arcbound creatures, it makes them... It's a copy of that card, except it's a 1/1. Oh, no.
Which is better.
Yeah, better than 0/0.
Better than a 0/0.
Better than a 0/0.
Yeah.
So Soul Separator is actually a really sweet card. I expect to see this, like, pop up in a lot of Commander decks.
Much more than Commander decks. It's a really sweet card.
The art is very sweet. Yeah. And then I have three different proliferate type things for some counters. We're doing some little sneaky counter stuff, and I have Ring of Three Wishes.
What would you have that one for?
To search out Mindslaver. And then the second wish, it'll be Arcbound Reclaimer, and then the third wish will be Contained Engine.
Okay. Well, okay.
Mindslaver.
And you don't have to wish for the Emrakul. He's already
Every
there.
Turn,
she's
yeah,
already there.
Yeah, she's hanging out.
He's never getting delirium.
What's going on with your deck tech over there? You know how uncomfortable this makes me for
what
two
are you
reasons.
About? Oh, so I'm playing spiders, and whenever we were setting up, they were like, put your stuff in order. I was like, spiders don't care about gravity. I don't.
Spiders don't care about order. They're agents of chaos. Yeah,
they get to hang out wherever they
want.
We're
just going to go ahead and...
Yeah.
My suggestion was that we tape the Ishkanah to the lens of the camera, because if we were to discover an Ishkanah in real life, that's where it would be. Like, you know,
no, it'd be behind you.
Well, the most inconvenient spot when you're, like, looking for a spider.
I think it'd be on top of the store.
Yes.
Actual Ishkanah.
I'm playing Ishkanah. You have to say it like that because it's a spider.
Yeah, I think you do have to say
Ishkanah,
it.
Ishkanah, Graph Widow. Bunch of spiders in my deck. If you're not familiar with what Ishkanah does, reach 3/5 for 5 whenever it comes into play. If you have Delirium, you get 3/1/2 spiders. 6 and a black. Target opponent loses 1 life for each spider you control. So Justin Parnell is going to have a whole new reason to hate spiders after this.
When I take control of his turn, it makes Steven lose a bunch of life.
What?
Nope.
That's true.
Nope. We have
Zendikar, original Zendikar, draft all-star, Ornery Recluse. Assault Formation, Eldritch Evolution, which is probably one of my favorite cards out of the new set.
It's a great card.
And I'm just going to spider some people out today, I think.
You have an Arachnogenesis.
I do have an Arachnogenesis.
This is a terrifying spider card.
I wasn't
going
to say it because I was hoping that... I didn't think about it until afterward. I kind of wanted to sneak up on somebody, so I was kind of hoping it would escape.
Shouldn't have deck decked it.
Yeah. Shouldn't have deck decked it.
I thought it was going to be in your deck anyway.
Oh, and then we also have Honorary Spider, Oracle of Moldiah.
Oh, jeez. Why not?
All right, so we have zombies, we have spiders...
Tentacle monsters.
Tentacles.
And werewolves. And, all the things that make great environments for living in Innistrad.
What an awful place. Holy crap.
I think somebody pointed out on Twitter, though, the fact that that Emrakul was invading Innistrad. People were just kind of not fazed by it at all. They were like, well, that thing's something got a lot of tentacles.
Yeah.
Get my pitchfork. I'm going to go get it.
People are like, what is going on?
They're like sharpened pitchfork.
They have their hands on their hips, and they start sweating, and then like a tentacle comes up and like wipes their brow. It's like, you can't figure it out.
So yeah, I'm playing Ulrich of the Kraylan Horde, and it is the legendary werewolf that everybody was...
That you've all been waiting for.
Yeah, that everybody's been waiting for since the original Innistrad. He is a 4-4 whenever this creature enters a battlefield or transforms into Ulrich of the Kraylan Horde. Target creature gets +4/+4 until end of turn, and he's got the usual werewolf clause of at the beginning of your upkeep, if no spells were cast, transform him, and he becomes Ulrich Uncontested Alpha, a 6/6 that whenever it transforms into Ulrich Uncontested Alpha, you may have it fight target non-werewolf creature you don't control, and has the usual werewolf addendum of at the beginning of each upkeep, if a player casts two or more spells, transform it back. So it keeps flipping back and forth for 0 and 2. It is one player cast two or more spells that turn, though. To go along with him, we've got some classics from original Innistrad. We got Curse of Stalk Prey, an enchantment that I can put on another person.
So you put it on Wes.
Everybody that...
Probably.
Every creature that attacks him gets a +1/+1 counter on it.
That one deals this one says combat damage.
This one does say combat damage.
I have a
funny
story about
that. There is the green
one
from Commander also in there that says whenever it just attacks.
Yeah.
Moon Mist to transform all my humans into werewolves, and it also fogs, can't be... combat damage that would be dealt this turn by creatures other than werewolves and wolves is prevented.
Looks like I got zombies.
Yep.
You do have zombies.
What is that stack of cards?
I don't know what you're talking about. So we also have Overwhelming Stampede to get through because some of them have trample, some of them don't. Spirit of the Hunt, which is new. Flash 3-3. I think this is the one that people were excited for pretty early in preview season. When it enters the battlefield, each other creature you control that's a wolf or werewolf gets +0/+3 in this turn.
That's a lot of toughness.
It really is. It can just blow people out on.
Oh, so those are the only wolf things you have.
And then this Huntmaster of the Fells, which everybody wanted to be the legend, all of these werewolves.
I'm really glad that wasn't legend.
All of these cards flip. Everything in this stack.
Including that Arlen Cord.
Yeah, look at it. Look at this foil Arlen Cord right here.
Including Arlen. Eh, she's not foil.
Oh, it looks foil for me.
Yeah. But yeah, I tried to get as many
Buyer
as I could.
Buyer of Magic Cards, Stephen Green.
There was a foil card right beside it, too.
That looks foil to me.
That Handwear Watch Keep is foil, definitely. I also have the Battlements. And the other one
somewhere in there.
Yeah, he's somewhere in here. But yeah,
we're supposed to only have 6 cards out.
This is the 6th card. Is all of the flip
Steven,
cards.
Steven, of all people, you have broken that rule more than anyone else. I don't want to hear it. Okay, so before we jump into the game, we do have a quick leaderboard update. Just to run it down really quick, Steven, you got 1 point last week. You're in 4th place with 4.
Loser.
No, I'm not.
Yes.
I'm tied for 3rd.
No, Jeremy's also tied for 4th.
No, we're tied for 3rd.
Tied for 4th. But Jeremy got 3 points last week, 2 for getting 3rd, and 1 for first blood.
Let's hear who's in number 1.
Wes, that would be you in 2nd place.
Oh.
You did get, you got 4 points last week. You got 3 for getting 2nd and 1 for having the cheapest deck. The bonus point, I got 4 for 1st again and 1 for that old general damage kill on Jeremy.
Yeah.
The Lord had to come down
and
treasure horn him good.
I do want to point out that I got both of them. So the people are going to hopefully see some melding, there might even though be, we don't have Brisella on here.
There may be some melding.
There's only one way to find out.
There's only one way to find out, and if you guys are ready, we'll see you in the game.
What you got with those cards there?
Since both of these two are tied for last place.
Third place.
Last place.
Tied and for third. And third.
We're still on the podium, all right?
I want to point something out really fast. Place. One of them can be attacked and not lose a point.
No, you have to be in sole possession.
I know. I said and not lose a point.
Oh, you're right. Both of them can be attacked and not lose
yeah,
a point.
Yeah.
It's great.
Wes, would you like to choose
who goes
first? You should choose Jeremy.
Jeremy.
Excellent choice. That awesome. Was Steven.
All right, I'm ready. You guys ready?
I've that's changed. Actually,
Steven, you're officially in last place since you're going first.
That's true.
It's okay. Is it? Can we go?
Can I?
Yeah.
Can I go?
Do it. Yep. Grape crawler. Let's get some.
Oh, jeez.
You know who's getting attacked first?
Probably me.
You. Tap that land. Yeah.
You're getting attacked first.
Man.
You know what?
Out of principle.
You know what?
Yeah. That's fine. Ornreef.
Yeah. Just cast that Ornreef. That's right.
Casting that.
Two damage coming at you.
Oh man.
Forced. Oh yeah.
Can somebody else block for me, please?
No, they cannot block for you.
Wes, do you have Ornreef in your deck?
I do.
I do, too. Go ahead.
No, that's
you have the ruins of Ornreef.
This one's all ooh, nice and shiny.
I murdered your Ornreef.
We will go ahead and attack.
You didn't suck the life out of it.
We'll go ahead and attack.
My people did.
Sorry. Jeremy.
Oh, boy.
This is for the last video. You remember the last video, Jeremy?
No, what happened last video?
I offered you sole possession of third place, and you spit in my face.
I believe that this was revenge for me taking your first blood last time.
Oh, don't even talk about that. I'll play a Tainted Isle.
I do think that's exactly what it was.
Shut up. Maybe it is.
Shut up.
Shut up, Charita.
It's a great movie.
Full Moon's Rise. Werewolf creatures.
What does a full moon to know?
Get +1/+0 and have Trample, sacrifice it, regenerate all werewolf creatures you control.
That seems pretty good.
Yeah, it's not bad.
I'm playing Mono.
Go ahead.
Mono don't interact with enchantments, so...
That is true.
That was my hope.
Only one person can save us from enchantments.
Who?
You.
Ishkanah.
He's not saving him.
I'll tell you what I can do.
Oh, can you sack this?
I could sack assault it. Formation.
Only one of us can save us from enchantments, Steven, and it's Jeremy.
No!
Well, as I'm going to do on the vast majority of my turns, I'm going to play land and pass the turn.
Oh, so it is just...
I will say this. I can't do a whole lot about enchantments. I can do some about enchantments. But if you need a creature with flying dealt with, I got you.
Nah, we don't need to worry about creatures with flying.
I'm going to play a cemetery.
Just let
those zombies creatures you control get +1/+1.
Other zombie creatures you control get +1/+1. I'm going to attack Wes for 3.
For 3?
Yeah.
There's so many.
Right there.
No, I know.
He's going to attack me for 4 next time.
Yep. Probably he's gonna.
I'm gonna need another lord for that. And as the people at home could tell you,
man,
I don't have that.
Yeah, that I'm probably just gonna do that.
That's correct. It is a yet.
I'm gonna do 3, and I'm gonna cultivate for now.
Oh God, I wish I had a cultivate. I dream of cultivating.
I'm gonna get
like often.
Yeah, all the time.
Forest into my hand and another mountain.
Cultivating and exercising. That's all.
That can't be all that you dream of. Gucci loafers has got to be up on the list. Apple watches.
Apple.
Hunter green Porsches.
Hunter green Porsches.
Hunter green Porsches.
Yes, Greg bought a hunter green Porsche for me.
Hated by
it's in the right color.
That's not important though.
Is it camo green?
Go ahead.
No, it's hunter green. Hunter
it's
green.
Malachite you're green.
Are you done?
Whatever you want to say.
You were doing okay till you said it was malachite green.
That's what I had to take the title and to go get tags for it.
That's whoa, Junk Diver.
Hey, that diver. Card is junk.
Yeah, it is right now. It's not very good. I'm going to pass the turn.
Now our goal should be to kill it before it can do anything.
You have plenty of time. you really have a lot of time.
Look at all that zombies going on. Oh.
I'm going to cast the Door of Destinies.
He's going to get the door.
And then we're going to bash Jeremy.
There's only one person that hasn't been attacked yet.
Steven hasn't been attacked. That's a good call.
Two.
Make sure to get him.
You're going
to
take 5.
Yeah, Jeremy.
33.
Yeah.
I hold vendettas. It's not like you didn't know this ahead of time.
That's right. There's people from the third grade he still hates.
Exactly.
I don't doubt that.
You're up.
Okay.
That is actually true.
There are people from third grade I hate.
I totally forget.
Yeah. Third grade's a hard time.
I'm not
going to
do that right
now.
I'm not going to do that.
One little social slip up, then that's like a nickname for life.
It's true.
Yeah.
Do you remember a specific name?
This.
No, I didn't have one. I just wanted to say
What's
that.
This?
No, I meant of a person that you don't
like. I'm going to cast.
I'm not going to say it.
Ulrich's Kindred, which is a 3/2 trample.
You
want
to put a counter on your green creature? Oh, wait.
Oh, wait. Oh, what have I done?
Oh, no.
Oh, wait. He gets plus one, plus zero, and trample. So.
Yeah, I was talking about with your ornery.
Yeah.
Oh, thank goodness it gets trample from that enchantment.
Yeah. It's got double trample.
Whatever it's got so much trample.
Whatever you say.
I'm done with
it. It's trample so hard.
Does that flip?
This one, no. It's
what a great werewolf.
He's indestructible. That's pretty good.
Wait, what?
Gives target attacking wolf or werewolf indestructible for three and turn three and a green.
This is not going the way I want it to go.
Where's your giant spiders at?
Don't worry about my giant spiders.
Hey, are you playing giant trapdoor spider? No, because it's red and green.
Yeah.
He's the only one without reach.
Without reach, yeah.
I'm going to save this for a...
rainy day
to go get an oracle and we'll die, but I think I'm gonna do it for three now just to
get a spider.
Somebody's running out of lands.
Hey, what's the name of that movie?
I know what Desperation Green Sun is when I see it.
Is your deck name Eight-Legged Freaks?
No.
David Arquette?
Yeah, it's a
great
movie.
Boy, that's a stinker.
It's so good. Don't hate.
It's poor.
You let me know when I'm almost out of time. I'm pretty sure I'm picking this one.
What? We don't. That's not how this works.
All right.
You get a counter up on screen.
That's it.
I'm pretty sure
Next Weaver?
It's right around here somewhere right now.
No.
Yeah.
No, I'm just pointing at random places.
I'm going to play Winding Canyons.
What does that do?
until end of turn, I can play creature cards whenever I can play instants, but I have to pay two. Okay, also, it produces colorless mana. Most importantly.
You've got the most expensive mana base among us, I believe.
I'm not going to be blocking, and I can't. I'll never be able to attack Wes with this junk diver.
Well, that junk diver.
I'll take one. It's fine.
No. I want you to stay at 40 because then people might attack you instead of me. I'm going to attack Jeremy. Okay. Jeremy goes at 32.
I'm attacking myself next turn.
I'll play Hedron Matrix.
Okay.
My junk diver might get +3/+3.
It might.
So my go?
I can attack through that Nyx Weaver then.
So my go now?
Yeah. That wasn't a mountain.
Play a Temple of the False God.
I can't wait till we get into crunch time and he does draw a mountain, like one stuck in there by mistake.
What?
We will cast a Gisa and a Giraffe. So I will mill the top four. Ooh, I wanted that card.
Two.
A three. Three.
No zombie.
Ooh,
that's a really good zombie.
I get a counter because I played a zombie.
No, you didn't. That's a human wizard. Come on, Steven.
He's trying to cheat.
You're better than that.
He's trying to cheat. He knew.
He was like, I'm playing a zombie.
I thought I would get a cheap one, but I didn't. Yeah, we're attacking Justin.
Yeah, I'll take
five.
We got a 35.
We all knew that was happening.
You're up, sir.
There's no surprises here.
All right, time to attack Steven. He's the only one at 40.
Draw.
The only way we can stop him is if he's dead.
You guys don't have to attack me. I spread the love out. I didn't target anyone except Jeremy.
That's very true.
You deserved it.
I'm also feeling
the
love here.
Cast Ulrich von Lichtenstein.
Am
unbeatable
I?
On a horse.
What?
It's like you've never seen a Heath Ledger movie.
What was he in?
A Knight's Tale. His name is Ulrich von Lichtenstein.
And what else was he in?
Batman.
And what else was he in?
Brokeback Mountain.
You.
And what?
Brokeback Mountain.
I was wondering how long you guys could go.
Brokeback Mountain's a great movie.
I've actually seen all those movies. Yeah,
I'm gonna put a plus one.
Whoa!
What? Yeah. You're gonna
do something.
Just kidding.
Go ahead.
Yeah. +1/+1 counter. That's all. Whenever it enters the battlefield, we're gonna give this +4/+4 until end of turn.
That's so much.
So many.
And coming at Steven.
Ha.
How much is that?
I'm just kidding. I'm gonna take.
You're gonna block.
Eight.
No, I'm gonna take seven.
You're going to take eight.
Oh, eight because of this, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
32.
All right, Wes is on the throne. Tag him.
Yeah.
Jeremy, you and I are going to be friends.
Yeah.
This is very, my card this is a very aggressive.
Are we to be
video.
so good of a friends that you're just going to play my turns for me?
Are you done?
I'm not even.
All right. I'll keep. I'm going to put the top two cards in my library.
This lovely lady still costs 13, so.
A two.
You have other ways.
Don't you need delirium to make him cost less? A basic delirium.
Super delirium. He can get real.
Was it seven?
She can make you get real crazy.
Seven, right?
Eight. You can have it cost five.
What's the eighth?
Tribal.
Tribal, yeah.
Planeswalker.
I always thought Tremorgloth was 7-8, but I guess it could be an 8-9. I've never seen an 8-9.
Mythical 8-9.
I've literally never seen that.
Yeah, it almost never happened.
I always like to say, you know, the Tremorgloth has two arts, right? There's the Future Sight art, and then the Modern Masters art. The Future Sight art's a 4-5 Tremorgloth. The Modern Masters art's
an
8-9
Tremorgloth.
That's pretty good.
If you look, there's a deer in that picture. It's like really tiny.
Is that a skull muncher?
I'm gonna skull muncher.
That's a snake.
Back.
And who else? You have to choose. Don't you choose?
I
someone
do
else?
Have to choose someone else.
No, give it. Put the undead war chief back in his hand.
He gets to pick.
Let me read this.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, you can choose me.
Yeah, I think it would be strategically.
Your hand and
actually, hey, you, I'll be friends with you. They're trying to form an alliance. I'll form an alliance with you.
Well, how am I forming an alliance?
Yeah. Because you guys are just sitting there talking about being friends.
What?
I'm going to take that. I'm going to take this.
Wes, okay, all I was saying is I can't cast any spells because all my spells cost like 8.
And after that, I'm done.
I will literally be unable to do anything. Yes. Land.
Cross those fingers that you're unable to do anything.
But that deck's going to go...
I have a spell.
It might take a little while to go from 0 to 100, but once it gets to...
It's not real quick, though.
What does the mirror works do?
Whenever another non-token artifact enters the battlefield under my control, I can pay 2. If I do, I put a token that's a copy.
Is it Mindslaver Legendary?
Yeah, it
is.
I'll block. That doesn't
does it
have
work?
Reach. Yeah. Steven, you got a 31.
Justin...
Go ahead. That was my one poke.
You're about to hit the pain train.
Woo! Woo-woo! Woo-woo!
What's up?
No spells.
Did you say no spells?
Yeah, just all of you. Just no spells.
No so I can spells flip this over till...
Brooklyn!
Thank you.
What do I want to do?
Oh, I feel like
turn.
Most of our audience had no idea what we're talking about. But...
No, but you can Google the Beastie Boys later if you want to.
Yeah.
I'm going to cast
then we're
out of my graveyard
like 100 comments.
An undead war chief.
I
guess what I get this
terrible.
Time.
Yeah.
This time I get
how
a counter on door death.
What are these white guys talking about?
That's where that you got to fight
what
for your
is,
right to party.
What
came
is a
from.
Brass monkey?
And then
what is with this robot
I will
fighting
cast
intergalactic?
Yeah. An undead alchemist.
Really
what? Oh no, I lost him last week.
We saw that guy already,
Steven. I thought you were playing around,
this
but now
you've... This is getting out of hand.
All right,
yeah,
then.
Kill Steven for
yeah,
sure.
Yeah, you gotta kill me for sure. Hey, Justin,
but I'm
what
not
does
the
this
one,
say?
I'm not the one doing
if
it.
If a zombie you control will deal combat damage to a player, instead that player puts that many cards from the top of his or her library into her graveyard.
Hey, yeah, attack me.
You gonna block?
I don't know, maybe.
He wants... Look, he's doing...
You
don't
even have enough
stuff.
I'm trying to get delirium.
You don't even have enough... Yeah,
I will have
man,
I have no
bluff
block.
Calls.
This is how big is this?
5 currently.
5?
Actually, it's a 6/5.
Man, I will
I have no
attack,
blockers. That's so crazy.
You with Gravecrawler.
That's so many.
Justin is going to be hit with.
Steven should have only taken 7 because it's actually just werewolf creatures and
oh
wolf. I apologize.
This is outrageous.
32 cheaters.
So go delete your comment
we
if you
caught
33.
That.
33. You gained 1.
He's
yeah,
at
I'm at
32. He took one from your thing last
time. Oh, yes.
Yep.
And I will attack Justin with the Cemetery Reaper.
What are you attacking
so
me with?
This is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And this one is 2, 3, 4, 5.
You can attack me with something.
This is
if it's going to mill me. Is it going to mill me?
1, 2, 3, 4.
This is others.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is +2/+1, Steven. Don't you know?
Oh, my
gosh.
Calm down, okay?
What are we
doing? 4, 5, 6. 7 right here and 6 right here. So 7 at you, 6 at you.
7 at me.
7. If you choose not to block, you will mill 7 cards.
Hey.
If you happen to mill a creature card, I get a 2/2 zombie and it gets exiled.
1,
yeah.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'll be drawing that one next turn.
Hmm.
You have chosen. Put Scarecrow.
I'll get a zombie. Zombie.
Okay. Do I want to block this for 7?
Oh, please block it.
Because it's a 7-6 right now?
That is correct.
And then it can come back?
That's could gross. Easily come back and make Dwarf Destinies even better.
Yeah, that's really
if
good.
If you block it, it won't come back.
Okay.
I guarantee it.
All right, block.
Is that a 6?
He's a werewolf.
5.
So 5-6.
Yeah. So, that's what I'm saying. Is it a 6?
Yeah, he's a 6.
Yep.
Wait.
He's a 6-5 because he had plus 1 from full moon shards. And then I should have had a counter.
I believe.
And you have a counter too.
I didn't actually expect you to block.
That's fine. Like, I kind of want to replay him from there a couple of times.
Yeah. If you play him 4 times, you get a point, I think.
Motherland. We're going to go with. We can do this. 1, 2, 3, 4. My own door. We're going to choose.
There's so many doors running around.
Werewolf.
So, just to be clear, I didn't say a creature type when Dwarf Destinies came into play.
We all kind of assumed.
But it's actually zombies. Wizard.
It's fungus? Fungus among us.
I assumed it was human since you tried to put a counter on when you cast Gisa and Geralf.
Do you know what else is a really good card with Gisa and Geralf? Zombie Apocalypse.
Yeah, that's a human.
And then.
It is.
I'm going to also make sure this
sometimes the zombies get a little overwhelming.
Okay. Man.
Mayor comes into town. Other humans you control, or other human creatures. Yeah. And then at the beginning of each upkeep, no spells.
The other one that gives the 1/1s, okay.
Yeah.
Well, 3/3s, but whatever.
And then give him, yeah. And then, right now we have a 3/2.
Did you choose werewolf or wolf?
I chose werewolf.
All right. Bring it.
Werewolf.
I have a much bigger than a 3/2 right now.
Yeah, I know. It's gross.
Upkeep, Nyx Weaver. 1.
A 2.
So what'd you get?
Spidery Grasp and Forest.
And is that where they're hanging from the camera lens?
Is it Spidery Grasp?
Oh, God, no!
They're very thematic together, Spidery Grasp in a forest, though.
All right. Yeah, every time you walk through a forest, I'm going to poke you a little bit, Steven, but it's not going to be that bad.
I don't know what
I'm going to remove your grave crawler from the game. I would have saved it, but I really need a second black.
Get out of here, grave crawler. Never to be seen again.
I'm just going to actually move these.
I guess I could have attacked Justin, but
he's fine.
I'm pretty sure Justin's about to start going ham.
I don't want to play this soon because I can't.
You don't have delirium.
Well, don't play another card from your hand.
I will.
It's the really secondary thing is still really good. Oh, it costs 7. I thought it cost 5. That would have been much better at 5.
I'm going to evolve.
That's a powerful card.
Yeah.
I am going to evolve.
So you're going to evolve
five drop?
Up to 6?
Get you an upgrade.
Up to 5.
Is plus 2?
It doesn't like shuffle in or anything, right? No.
So you have exile you now have delirium,
yeah, it
though, right?
Exiles it.
Oh, no, you don't. It exiles.
Yeah.
He has delirium. Is enchantment, creature, land, and sorcery?
No. He has 2 instances.
Oh, so he didn't sack his enchantment creature to turn on delirium.
No, because I want that.
Yeah, he's going to probably turn on delirium next turn because he's putting it in stuff in his
he hopes.
Yeah, no kidding. I'm probably going to get Pray for Insanity just because me and
that
Oracle
sounds like the name of a magic card.
What?
Pray for Insanity.
Yeah. That's actually a good mitten. Hey, flavor people at Wizards.
Maldaya, yeah.
Got that one for free, I guess.
Yeah. Wow. That is so
crazy.
Oh,
what a surprise!
I would have never expected guessed. Oracle of Maldaya from Westwise.
We all know. It's no secret.
You know when you know where your bread's buttered, and that's okay.
Where's your bread buttered?
Both sides with Oracle and Maldaya. Oh, wow, I totally just dropped a card in my hand.
Whoa.
You cheater.
Well, it's facing another direction. It fell out, though.
Savage cheats.
So you got caught like Mike Long.
Hey-o. You want to cut before?
After that, absolutely.
Camera can verify, hand's still the same.
I can't even talk. I tried to attempt to cheat him out of the game.
It's a hidden spider.
It's not doing a very good job.
No, it's delirium, though. It's delirium.
Well, that's true. It's an enchantment.
It will, yeah. Go ahead.
All right.
All you have to do is control his next turn.
Please don't.
So you can sacrifice the Nyx Weaver before. Or you can control my next turn.
Or you can do nothing. I vote for do nothing.
pass the turn.
Oh, Lord, he's
I'm going to attempt five. I'm going to play Mimic Vat for three and make another Mimic Vat.
Well, that's not good.
Would you guys say that that's the biggest flavor fail on the face of the
planet? Yeah. In Spider.
In Spider.
It's like, he's waiting.
He's a very visible Hidden Spider, yeah.
I'm going to pass the turn.
You know what I think the worst part about being an insect would be? It's that vampires are real in your world. They actually yeah. exist.
That's it.
That's, and called... that's really terrifying.
Yeah, I know, right?
Jeez. All right, Steven.
Yeah? Dun-dun-dun-dun-dun. What kind of zombie fun will we have this turn?
Hopefully it's not a hidden zombie. Because it might be on top of your deck.
Hidden zombies are the worst zombies.
I know, right? I hope, like, I really wanted to cast that, but I really want delirium first. Like,
I could see a hidden wolf, a hidden werewolf. Not, that's not
all right.
I've seen underworld. Since one popped out of nowhere.
Justin wants to play really good spells. We'll play something better than his.
Grave betrayal.
That's like immediate mimic that.
Man. Yeah, it is, isn't it? And they become zombies.
What?
They get +1/+1 counters, and they become zombies.
That's I knew gross. That. I just don't.
I knew
like
I should have played white.
I'm just. I'm just normally the one that has it. So like,
who's on the Wes? You're on the throne.
No, I'm not. It's fine.
It's so long. It's so long ago since Wes has been attacked.
Do I have to mill in place of taking damage, or in addition to taking damage?
In place.
All right.
So you actually milled last turn, right? You're still 35. I don't know why I marked you.
I'm still 35. Yeah. You wanted it all.
I'm going to attack Wes with this one. I'll throw you a bone.
Okay. All right.
Yeah. I'm ready.
I'm ready. I'm excited.
Wes here and Justin.
All right. Now, wait. Before you do this, I'll give you a minute so you can count it up.
I'm attacking.
No blocks.
He's just no blocks.
Okay. Okay. Four.
Uh-huh.
Five, six.
Uh-huh.
Seven, eight, nine.
That's so many.
All right, so this is you don't control, so you're the active player. So this is going to go under Mimic Vat if I block.
That's correct.
All right, I'm going to block.
That's why I said I was giving you one.
And
so but you don't take any damage, though.
It's put into the graveyard. I'm at
no,
so.
Yeah, I'm, into, okay. I'm just going to mill nine.
You're going to take nine, all right.
Junk Driver is going to trigger, and right. I'm going to return.
I think he was okay with that.
Yeah, I'm going to return Expedition.
So now. Here's one.
Because he's going to get delirium now.
Two. Three, four, because
I need lands.
Five,
making all sorts of spiders.
Six, seven, eight, nine.
How many creatures did you mill?
Oh, that's boy. It's okay.
At least one.
At least one.
It's it, you just get one token.
Yeah.
It's just if.
No.
If
he, oh he yeah, does. I did.
It's
yeah,
a, it's I, an I, if I, not
I,
one.
I get one.
It says whenever a creature card is put into an opponent's graveyard from his or her library, exile that card and put a 2/2.
It's a when, not if. Oh, you exile it. So this Scarecrow's exile?
Yes.
Okay.
It's for every occasion of a creature hitting.
Yeah, I hit one creature.
For every occasion.
Just one?
There's yep. Zombie.
Okay.
You also got my eaten by spiders.
I will be done.
Man, you're
gone. I'm not doing any damage, though.
That's true.
That's okay, yeah. You turn all of our life totals into 99. I got 99 hit points.
Not anymore.
No, not anymore. Mm. But I do have delirium now. I'm delirious.
I was helping you out.
You're so crazy.
Enchantment, land, instant planeswalker.
This
sorcery,
doesn't trigger after you make a copy of it.
Hidden spider.
I'm going to recast.
What?
Ulrich.
Tokens don't enter the graveyard.
Yes, they do. They hit the graveyard.
One, actually, it just says exile. So, yeah, Wes is right, but Steven's right because they exile.
Wow. Okay. Yeah. You're playing another Ulrich von Lichtenstein?
Von Lichtenstein, indeed. His banner. I can't do whatever it was Paul Bettany did in that movie.
Oh,
His announcements.
Yeah, don't try that.
He was too good.
He was
too good. So, Trigger on Door of Destinies.
This is though he is a professional.
Yeah. He does that on a regular basis. And then, let's see, what do I got here?
What you give him pluses to?
I'm going
to
give a plus to...
Oh, this is revealed.
The Trampler.
Probably Ulrich's Kindred.
Milling that one, bro.
And
is this the guy who's like always trying to hurt people?
Yeah, it's his puppy.
Okay,
so he's got +4, and then
that's it. You're gonna attack me?
I'm gonna attack Wes, I think.
For how much?
All right, how many am I milling?
He's like on the throne.
Seven.
Yeah, it's seven right now. It's all a seven.
I'm at 30.
Seven, six.
That's real damage.
Yeah, not this fake
Not Harry Potter damage.
Not this fake make your commander better.
Yeah. Anyone who actually played the Harry Potter card game will get that.
Done.
You milled.
Not yeah. Harry Potter damage.
I played that for like two or three times because they had them on sale for $5 or whatever.
Yeah, I bought like a box for like a dollar, yeah.
One, two, no land.
Oh, well, man. You got to draw that.
So. Yeah, you got to draw it.
Go ahead, put that in your hand.
No land, no land, no land,
no land, no land, no land.
Whoa, we did it.
What was that one?
Nephilia Academy.
Not familiar.
What's that?
If a spell or an ability an opponent controls would cause you to discard a card, you may reveal that card and put it on top of your library instead of putting it anywhere else.
Good thing I'm milling straight off your library.
Yeah.
Play one. Oh.
What is that one?
That'll get you more lands.
That will give me more lands, but I can't cast it until I cycle this card.
If you had a Dryad Arbor in your deck, you could put it on top and play it.
Hmm? Go ahead. Yeah, I could. I do have Dryad Arbor in my deck.
Oh, boy.
All right, cycle, draw. I played one land for the turn so
far.
Have. Oh, man, a Swamp Yard, too.
That's a Swarm Yard, not a Swamp Yard.
Sorry.
That can return.
Swamp Yards are over here.
That can
return. Swarm Yards are different.
Hmm.
Faster.
No. I kind of want to get some more manas. At instant speed. But I could play a land right now.
What's going on?
I need you to attack me with something so I can block it.
So you have two colorless mana floating? Is that right? Nope.
Nope.
I'm just going to play this. I'm not going to gamble.
Swamp Yard coming into play.
Swamp Yard.
That seems like a pretty good one. It regenerates like all of your creatures.
Is that Arachnogenesis on top of your library? Your
card. It is an Arachnogenesis.
I'm pretty sure you're getting attacked next turn.
Oracle Moldai is really bad at being sneaky.
What are you going to attack me with? Steven?
Something to mill that Arachnogenesis
off.
I can't have myself getting attacked by spiders.
How many spiders?
It depends on how many creatures you attack with.
I'm in a harrow.
Yes.
Aww.
No one's making me discard anything, are they?
Discarding? Yep.
The only thing I think that made you discard was this spell that I exiled. Compelling Deterrence.
I'm going to discard that then. Then I'm going to go get
two untapped basic lands.
Two untapped basic lands.
I'm guessing.
No, my library's messed up.
Who would have done that?
Probably me.
Are you going to spill your entire library into your hand again?
No. It's going to be a force and a swamp.
I do believe you should take time right now to rearrange all of it, though.
I thought about it for a minute.
Let me just go ahead and set this up how I need to. And
no, I think what I did was whenever I picked him up to mill, I put him back the wrong way.
Mm. Yeah, we'll say it wasn't the first time you shuffled.
Alrighty. And then after that, this is going to be a really weird question. Does anybody have any equipment out? I don't see any. Oh, you do. You mean you used to have some equipment out?
Sure. You just playing a random.
Why not?
Is that what that does?
Actually, I have delirium now. Just kidding.
So I was like, I'll be honest. You're not going to be hurting my feelings if Hedron Matrix goes away.
All right.
So you get three
spatters.
That's kind of a lot.
Three for he's get what?
Three, six, one, two green spiders.
Six power, eight toughness on four bodies.
That's six power, 11.
Oh, 11. Oh, they're one, twos. Yeah.
Oh, that's 11 right. Power, big. 11 toughness.
Oh, boy.
Jeez. Yeah.
They got real, oh, and real is, quick.
It's kind of seems really good.
Did you say 11 power, 11 toughness?
Because it's all permission.
Yep.
Oh.
They all butt fight.
Yeah, bring it.
Yeah. Okay.
Bring it.
Mine are larger.
All his creatures.
Yeah, but even if I don't block it,
butt fight.
Spider right. Face with that Oakland booty.
I'm done.
All right. Draw.
I need to rearrange my board. People complain too much on YouTube about my board.
You do a really bad
I
job.
I think they complain exactly the right amount.
Enough to get you to notice.
They're spiders. They don't care about gravity. Remember?
That's true.
You just put
lands,
wherever you want.
My lands clearly care about gravity.
They're that's agents true. Of chaos. First off, this spider decided he's going to be over here, half under right.
The spider
table.
Is going to be right up in Justin's.
No, I'm going to play Expedition Map, and I'm going to copy it with Mirror Works.
Oh, man, that's
we
so
We see where this is getting out of hand.
I'm going to sacrifice this fake Expedition Map.
Yeah.
That's so nice of you to not make us
Faux Edition map.
Expedition map.
Next time I need you to keep a fake one out.
One of these days I'm going to attack somebody.
That new art is really sweet.
And on that day you will
this art is great.
Yeah.
Go on.
I like a lot of the art in this set.
I'm going to attack with my zombies next turn.
And then?
I don't know. Maybe you'll just let me mill you.
I'm gonna be done after that. Okay. I just wanted to play this one. So during Steven's turn, you can go ahead. This is not going to affect anything. I'm just going to crack this one.
Did you see two for
close?
That?
I did.
Actually looked at this up close yet.
Oh, my gosh. I did not. Yeah.
Yeah, the art is sweet.
So. I totally didn't even know what art that was. Yeah. I did not recognize that as a temple.
I'm going to get Shrine of the Forsaken Gods with the second one.
That was like the first time I saw it, too. I completely didn't even think of it was a temple. And then
it's beautiful.
But the new
it's
art is really art. Sweet.
I'm going to cast Call
I wish this the was, I wish this was a playmat.
And then? Mm-hmm. That's a...
Oh, boy.
At the beginning, they sacrifice a non-zombie?
Yes.
Yeah.
Mm.
That's gross.
It is kind of gross. And then, after that...
And then?
I'm going to attack... Well, I can't really attack you. How big is this kind of? 3-5?
5-5.
What 5?
But it's 3-5.
Yeah, 3-5, yes. Yeah.
So we'll do one zombie at Jeremy, one zombie at you.
And how big is your zombies?
2, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7-7. 7 6s.
Boop.
Yeah, I guess.
Yep.
Bye-bye, spider.
Mm. 7 6s.
You stepped on him. Did that make you feel better?
I'm gonna mill 7, I guess.
Yeah.
1.
A 1.
2.
A 2.
3. 4. 5. Oh, 6. 7. 2.
Undead Alchemist.
It's doing work.
I think I've had enough.
Yeah, he's getting... This one's also... It's at the beginning of the end step.
I think a lot can be said about that. Mirror works.
No creatures are in the battlefield. Sacrifice it.
Yeah.
Mimic Vat, I think I've had enough.
Yep.
I haven't had enough of Mimic Vat yet.
So untap, upkeep.
That's correct.
Sacrifice a non-zombie.
Yes.
Hmm. I'm just going to sacrifice this wolf. You get it.
Wait, who gets it first?
He gets it. His trigger hits first.
I'm the active player.
And then my trigger
hits. Well, Jeremy's the active player. Then it goes to you. Then it goes to me. I have triggers.
Yeah.
All right.
So wait. I have two. So this one, then this one.
Sure. And then he has one in his results first, right?
Rats.
Yes. Yeah. Return it under your control.
Yeah, he can do it.
Oh.
It's a zombie.
Sorry.
And it has a counter.
Insects. Come on, man.
All right, so draw for the trigger.
Spiders. Yep. Rats, insects, spiders.
I said.
Do
rats.
I get his tokens back?
No, tokens are not come cards. Back.
They die.
You were trying to argue against that earlier.
Well, they do die. You enlighten me, so I get them back.
Yeah.
It doesn't say return it from the graveyard. It just says return it.
I'm just going to go ahead and do this.
Where else would you return it from? The Nether?
It doesn't say.
No, harmonize. Droth.
Maybe.
Where could it come from, Wes? Where could it come from?
Three.
What do you
should
think
just
happens?
Not cast any spells and flipped your mana.
I probably could have been okay with that, but...
No, you got too much mana.
Yeah.
We'll just hope someone else does nothing one turn.
I'm going to mill one of you eventually.
Four to also cast Cruel War Chant.
Attacking
creature control gets plus one and can't be blocked except by two or more creatures.
Bang that drum.
I got a cursor group in my deck.
You're the one in trouble up here. If anyone's in trouble, it's the guy with no creatures.
Arnold is on.
What do you have in your graveyard? Land, currently. Artifact. Land and artifact. All right, so mirror,
you're
12
safe.
Mana. 11 mana. We have
you
access to
safe.
2, 3,
7.
What is this one?
Sanctum of Ugin.
Okay.
We'll go for 4, 5, 6, 7 at Parnell.
Ooh, Parnell.
Seems like a lot.
Well, it looks like I got you 28.
28.
28. 28. 7
with
Ulrich
damage. 7 Ulrich.
Only two more of those. And
7. You!
Go ahead.
Sure.
Nobody? All right. Well, I was saving the regenerate in case I needed it, but I guess I didn't need it. I could have had
didn't
an extra...
Didn't even regenerate your spider. You just let it
Well, I was saving it for in case he tried to kill or attack with... I think that was
a wise move. Hashtag wise move. Thanks, Internet.
Yes, thank you, commenters, for that one. I gotta find out that guy's name.
Oh, not my sting flinger.
All these
stinger flingers.
All these flying creatures.
Yeah, we gonna see that.
No!
Hey, it's more land.
It is more land.
It's what you've always wanted.
It is what
now I have a trampling zombie, even better.
Hmm.
There's one thing better than a regular zombie.
It's a trampling.
It's a trampling zombie.
Wes, attack me.
Why don't you calm down?
With Oracle, and we'll die.
Because
that's the one I really want.
Okay. So here's what's going to happen.
Tell me what you want.
What you really want.
Thank you, Wes.
You hear me? I refuse to use these.
Yeah.
Those are great.
Yeah, I'm not using those.
Those are great zombie tokens.
All right. I'm going to pay one a black and a green. And I'm going to exile my Nyx Weaver.
What would you get back?
Stinkflinger.
Then...
what could he possibly be doing?
Well, Oracle will die is in place. I don't know what he's getting back.
I'll get back my Liliana.
Okay, that's intriguing.
Yeah. And then...
Then I play my Liliana.
I'm going to sacrifice these three creatures.
Oh, there's a Dread Return in there.
Hey.
Yeah, Oracle.
Come on, give me an Oracle.
Oh, it's going to die in a minute.
No, you could give it right back to me.
Just let him do his thing.
Okay.
I don't have a dice. I'm just going to wait. If he's going to, like, wipe the board, there's no point.
Well, let's, you know.
I mean, these can say that they're zombies or something.
No, that actually messes up my stuff because I was going to get back the Oracle. You're right.
You're not, because it's mine now.
I'm going to flashback Dread Return. I'm going to get back a Skull Winder. My Skull Winder is
going to... Who will you choose?
Back a Wretched Confluence. And I'm going to let... Do you have anything in your graveyard?
Don't.
All right, Jeremy.
What do I get?
I'll give you something.
What is the lander?
It's anything, right?
Is it anything? It goes back into my hand?
Yep.
This Zenigo seems really good.
I like I'm going to attack Mr. Perdition. Green. I'm going to attack the green one.
I'll six. Block.
How big is it?
Big. Big enough. More than five.
All right.
Yeah.
Interesting. I figured it out. It was a damnation all along.
Yeah, this is really bad.
How are you going to cast those zombies again?
Ooh.
I was supposed to reveal it. So.
Oh, yeah, from the Oracle. Well,
it's not a smart move at all.
That sucks. Why?
There's two Mimic Bats in play.
They go to you.
No, this says I don't control.
Oh, yeah, whatever.
So, there's literally a trigger on all this stuff.
That is a bunch of triggers.
Yeah.
Well, I can only choose ones you do control.
Yes, but you have triggers for these too, which we can't choose this.
I mean, I can. I just wouldn't work.
I'm going to get those two, and you're just going to exile all these, I assume?
Hey, real talk, though.
What? No.
This comes into play, and you get triggers.
I'm gonna get Oracle. I'm going to get Oracle of Moldiah.
That's a good choice. I like Oracle.
I think I'm just going to get Oracle of Moldiah.
All right.
Yeah, keep your Junk Diver.
Yeah, I'll keep.
That means you get this, right?
You get both of these.
You get this one too?
I get this and this. Oh, no, that was
good. That one's just gone, right?
And then I make something back for that.
That goes.
For that Skull Winder. That comes, you actually get the ETB trigger for that, right?
Yes. I'm thinking. He's what do I want back? I'm going to take the Undead War Chief. Since that's clearly the best one.
That's probably pretty good.
And who else are you picking?
Choose, you must.
Yes.
So if you get Damnation back, I'm going to be really upset.
I think you should do it. Safety Valve.
That's actually not a bad idea.
You can't be too safe.
He swarmed us in pretty
early. I swarmed you for meal.
Yeah. And now you don't have the meal.
For meal.
I do have the meal.
I don't.
I have this.
That's a good choice.
Oh, that's
which
true.
Lets me do
that's
this choice. Again.
Yeah.
Done.
Yeah, you do.
What'd you get back?
Nothing.
Wes, is it Damnation?
It might be.
It was Damnation.
What did you get? You're just going to lie about it? Like, right. Is it Damnation?
Oh, wait. I don't even have Oracle in play yet.
Nope.
Get out of here. Cheaters. You're just sitting there watching me.
I wasn't watching you. I was having a conversation with him.
I was watching you and just letting it happen.
I wasn't paying attention.
No, that wasn't the thing.
To be honest.
Mimic Bat.
I'm actually just upset at my tapping. I didn't tap long.
All right, Oracle, you're back. I'm going to play a land for the turn. The Soul Ring.
No, that's my oracle.
That's correct.
I'm going to play a shrine of the Forsaken Gods. So...
What a colorless mana you got going on over there.
Two to cast colorless spells. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Seven, like, seems like a lot.
Well, it's probably... You're trying to get that balance, right? Between reducing and...
Yeah. It's a weird thing we must do. I don't really know where I'm going with any of this, I'll be honest.
I'm really just trying to figure out ways I can get this oracle and I'll die back.
I'm permanently exiled, so you can't.
No, it goes into the graveyard with memory afterwards, doesn't it?
When I replace it.
Yeah, when he replaces it.
That's right.
If.
That's right, Choi. If I replace it.
With the threat from behind the director's chair.
I really need to kill this Grave Betrayal. I'm less worried about the mimic.
One, two, three, four.
Every time
five,
you damnation my side, I don't get the stuff back, though.
Yeah, but how many times do I have to damnate? I have to damnation everyone's creatures twice.
I'm going
to
play Hangerback Walker X equals three.
That's also pretty good.
That's big.
I'm going to give it a counter.
It's all right.
Wes, that's only appropriate.
No!
I'm going to attack you for two with this Oracle.
It's only appropriate for a Grave Betrayal.
Nope.
I don't get it anyway. I get a trigger, it doesn't matter.
That's not what I'm talking about. I'm saying that it would be a betrayal from the grave.
Okay.
All right.
I'm done.
Good. I'm going to draw for my turn.
Hey.
Yeah, don't stop looking at Soul Ring.
Just you wait until I damnation again. One of these days.
Hedron Matrix, so good. With Hangerback Walker.
Yeah.
I'm going to cast Gisa and Geralf again.
Again.
Now, if this dies and it goes to Steven, it's a 0/0, right?
Nope, it's a 1/1.
It's a 1/1?
There's a Great Betrayal. Comes into play with a 1/1 counter on it.
And it's a zombie.
It's a 3/3. Yeah, that's so many.
It's a little annoying, but...
We'll go to attackers.
Bring it.
I will. Oh, it's my turn. So I can't attack Justin. We will attack you with the snake and you with the mayor.
Yes,
so
that's right.
4 and 4 to you.
24.
What are you at?
24. I just took 4, right?
Yeah.
I just missed a bunch of damage. When did you take a bunch of damage?
He took 7 damage.
Well, Oracle, but I had just attacked me.
He took 7 from an Ulrich.
Yeah.
Or something.
Oh, I made you gain life instead of lose life last turn. that would make
sense. I'm always a fan of that.
All right. What's Jeremy at?
28.
Okay. I had that one right.
And you're at 28?
Yeah, I'm at 28.
Mm.
And Steven's at 28, 32?
31?
I'm at 32 now. Cheater.
Did you gain a life?
Where have you been all game?
It's that same life where I didn't take the 1 damage off the wolf.
Lamb hold.
Who really knows? 32.
And this is mine.
I thought werewolves are supposed to be immortal.
No.
What?
Oh, it's the beginning. I thought it was the end.
Good Lord, Steven.
Jesus.
You're going to get it.
Let me get it.
Master, then I'll put...
Why'd you have to play that? Now I can't damnation, really.
You can?
Yeah, you absolutely can.
Absolutely can, damnation.
I am done after that.
You must sacrifice a creature. I'm just kidding. You're just going to say. No, I just wanted to do it at the end of turn.
He wants me to do it at the end of turn.
Steven, you don't know what any zombie cards do. None. I'm embarrassed for you.
You should be.
You know what makes me really uncomfortable? When people count.
All their lands?
With their fingers, specifically.
I'm going to cultivate.
Do it all the time.
It's even better. I'm going to play a Noxious Skull at some point.
You're going to get away with that one time.
One of these days.
I'm going to play a Noxious Skull at some point.
Get these
just two. To kill all your creatures.
More like Obnoxious Skull.
It will be obnoxious.
Obnoxious
if I get some more mana. You know that normal problem I have where I keep drawing land? not really struggling with it today.
Yeah, you're playing zombies. Well, you're playing.
Well, I did mill three.
Well, you're playing swamps. They are the most powerful of the lands.
Thank God I got rid of that. This isn't going to really go to the battlefield tapped. I'm going to play this one for the turn.
Okay.
If I play Liliana, there's no way she lives for the turn.
That's not true. But yeah, it's probably
true. Yeah, she'll definitely live through your turn.
It's not true, but it's probably true.
I have no beef for Liliana.
All right. Well, personally, give it a shot.
No beef at all.
You know what the best part about this is? It's a 1-1 counter.
There's a lot of good parts.
Well, you're probably going to die anyways, Liliana.
You could just give something negative anyway.
But what does that kill? That doesn't kill anything.
It doesn't kill anything. Just pumps your Liliana up.
Yeah, but if it's going to die anyways, I might as well just put some cards in the bin.
It's like you weren't even trying.
Put two target cards.
Well, if it's going to happen anyway, I'm just going to jump off this bridge.
Put two in these, and then I'm going to get return a creature card from my graveyard to my hand.
It's good. If I'm going to die anyway, if I'm supposed to jump off the bridge, I mean...
I'll take this Oracle back.
What is going on?
I was trying.
Pulling it from exile. That's what happened.
Pull from eternity.
Mm-hmm.
I guess I'll get back this It of Horde Swarm as my creature. Then I'm done.
All right. Upkeep. There's a trigger on the stack.
There is a trigger on the stack.
Grave Pack's on the stack. Pack on the stack.
Call to the Grave.
Call to the Grave.
Call to the Grave. Sorry, I'm so used to Grave Pack. I'm going to activate none of that.
What?
Yeah, we know what's up.
I'm going to put this into play. I'm going to let Call to the Grave resolve. I'm going to sacrifice this token. Token's going to go to the graveyard. I'm going to return a card.
So, I need to get that.
It's a token.
I need to get it.
Nope.
That's what you need.
You won't get it's it. And get. Steven, I think I've had enough. I'm going to get this Spine of Ishkanah.
Ooh.
I mean, it is what it is. I'm not even being mean to you. I'm being so nice to you.
I'm going
to
draw.
I think he's saying he wants all the creatures.
He's tired of you taking all of them from him.
It's my party, Steven.
Are you getting a Call to the Grave or a Grave Betrayal?
No, he'll cry if he wants to.
I'm going to play a Soul Ring. And when it enters the battlefield, I'm going to pay 2.
Oh, man.
I'm going to get another Soul Ring.
Oh, my gosh. Do you want a sleeve and like write it down somehow so we can...
That might be a good idea.
You could just literally put that token into play under a soul ring. Well, no, he's got 2 soul rings.
Yeah, these are soul rings.
Yeah. We keep them separated in the soul ring pile.
Gotta keep them separated.
All right.
More music.
You have enough to double spine?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I'm going to play Spine of Isha.
What does that do, Justin?
And I'm going to double it.
Double it?
I'm going to destroy target permanent. I'm going to choose Grave Betrayal.
And then?
Call to the Grave.
No, why would I choose Call to the Grave?
It only helped him now.
His is way better than mine.
Door of Destinies. Yeah, but I love zombies. That's the difference.
Oh, I see. Prejudice.
Fair enough. Okay. I am going to pass...
And a Sanctum of Ugin.
I thought
trigger.
I only did creatures.
It's a May. I do not want to sacrifice it.
You sure?
Yeah.
All right.
It's my go now?
It's your go. Game might stepping up, giving out. Mimic Dash, Soul Ring, Spine of Ishkanah.
Oracle will dies.
This set does have some sweet art, though. I was very excited about that one.
All right, Justin.
Yep.
Hey, Watsy, when am I going to get a Noxious School but for spiders?
Noxious spider.
Noxious spider.
After you just got your legendary
3/3 now.
Yep.
We all remember what happened with Noxious Bull last
time. Attack Wes for 3, and these are going to come at Justin.
Are you talking me or Liliana?
I'm taking you.
Okie doke.
Well, I just want to prove you wrong.
Liliana will never live.
You have 21, which will be 3 G and G.
So this is 5 and 5. They're both 5.
Both 5, yeah. It's 10.
Does seem like a lot.
Yeah, this is a good chunk of your electrol.
I'll put you to a mere 18.
Mirror 18?
But then I'll put Dobbers in a play, and you'll kill them.
You're
going to play a trick on me.
I might. But you'll get to put them underneath.
I don't...
Kill all.
You don't need a junk that
you know? It's just 5 life, whatever.
It's 10 life.
But I can't block both.
18.
I got 18.
You got to die first anyways, no offense.
Well, I mean, it's looking like it's going to happen.
And you're going to lose a point, too, because you haven't cast that journal yet? Mm.
Probably so.
That's obnoxious.
Obnoxious school?
Obnoxious school.
Yep.
Had that,
I knew it.
Get that cemetery reaper back.
I knew you were trying to trick me.
Gisa and Geralf. Upkeep.
What'd you get back with skull thingy?
Comes in.
Yeah,
sure. Sacrifice it.
Is that how that works?
I don't think you can do that.
What do you mean?
Because
I'm pretty sure yours
active,
hits the stack.
Active player, non-active player.
Yeah, I get to choose the order of the triggers because it's both at the beginning of the upkeep, right?
No, you choose the order of your triggers.
Oh, I don't control both. Okay.
Yeah.
So
your trigger's going to stack first since you're the active player.
Yeah.
And then they
his,
go around.
His result first.
His result
then
first.
Then Wes's, okay. Then mine, then Steven's.
I apologize then. I'll just sack the lamp. Then.
Would you like to put that under a mimic vat, sir?
Nay.
Nay.
Nay, okay. I say.
At least you get a wolf this way.
Yeah. Now I get a tiny wolf. Wolfie. All right. Draw for the turn.
That's too late.
It's the late.
The moment was over.
It's the late to the party wolf. It's the yipper dog wolf.
If you that one looks like a dog.
He does.
No, he looks like a yipper wolf. That's why he was late.
Is that the younger brother, Emmer Wolf?
Yeah, yes. Probably. Guys, why can't I play? I want to come.
All right.
That's my audition for voice acting for Disney movies.
What are you doing?
I'm just going to get
all right, I'm asking.
Oh, no. Jägermeister of the Fells.
Jägermeister of the Fells.
Hey, when he comes in play. Don't insult him like that.
Or transforms.
This is a German name.
Jeremy goes to 30.
Is it?
Yep. Yeah, Jägermeister.
Oh.
Not 30. Exactly Jägermeister.
It is. Like verbatim Jägermeister.
Is it?
Yeah. That's what Jägermeister means, huntsman.
But not huntmaster. I mean,
it's
I guess
supposed
you,
to have the.
Like, I guess you
that's,
can.
That's what the actual like yeah. German card is, though.
Yeah.
Okay.
Tap.
Learn something every day.
Like Jägermeister used to have like wolf's blood in it or something. Supposedly, when they first made it.
There's no way it could taste
good
any
Lord,
grosser.
That's a little.
I'm. So, you guys like people hate on me for hating on Timmy Hortons, which is like totally understandable. But I don't think you can hate on a person for not liking Jägermeister.
Timmy Hortons.
What, you mean wolf's blood?
Yeah.
All right.
I don't mess around with that.
So these are 3, 4.
Are
no,
they,
these are wolves.
Wolves
it's just werewolves. Yeah, I'm sorry. So it's 3s.
This is a werewolf.
Yeah, he's a... He can't.
He's not going to be tapped.
Tapped for...
He won't be tapped...
He refuses to be tapped.
I refuse.
Your zombies are really big, though.
They're large and in charge.
What do we at now? So we got 4. And this is a 5, 6, 7. That's a 7-7. That's a 7-9. Jeez, oh, peace.
Yes.
Jeez,
this is a
6-6.
That's a 6-6.
And
this
is
did we forget?
This is a 4-4. It's a human.
Hey,
yeah,
what did,
a human.
What did you sacrifice to call to the grave?
That elder?
Lamp, hold on.
Nah, Steven.
I don't.
Non-zombie.
Each player's non-zombie. Oh.
Rats.
3-1. Oh, man.
We're just going to take the 3 damage from Wes back, because that's who I attacked. Yeah, you're still at 24.
24.
Yes.
And then would you...
Wouldn't it be really funny if I still went to 21 at the end of this turn?
Yes, I gained 2 life also. I'm at 20.
No, you didn't. No. I attacked you before that. That's still 5.
Rats, 18.
Yeah.
Okay, 18 still.
No.
We apologize for the viewers at home.
We found it, and you didn't think we would. You all commented before.
You were all on just like on the bandwagon. They'll never see it.
Yes, a mistake. I love mistakes.
Okay.
I'm not mocking you.
The best part is, I counted this trigger.
You're right, he was mocking Tim Horton and Jägermeister. Why do you feel about that, Internet?
I counted this trigger on this, but I missed this whole thing.
Yeah, you're like...
It's a zombie. Why wouldn't it be?
Since you have Call of the Grave, I'm just never going to play another creature. I don't want him to die. I like them all.
Each creature you control that's a wolf or a werewolf gets +1/+1 and has trample.
Mm-hmm. They've got so many tramples.
Hmm. Well, you can only attack with one of them.
That's
well,
all right, because my stuff has reach a whole bunch, too.
You can tap him to fight something. That's
all
true.
All untapped werewolves I control. And that is
this is wolves. This is just wolves,
yeah,
right?
It's just all untapped wolves I control. I'm sorry. So I can tap him. These are now 4/4s. And so they can take out that guy, I think.
He is a 6/6.
Yeah. They will take him out. Yeah. One of them will live.
Yeah, we'll do it that way.
Does he not have werewolves too? Is it just
wolves? No, it's just wolves. Okay. Yeah, I wanted to double
check. Yeah, read Huntmaster Master of the Wild Hunt.
Yep. And then is it controller chooses between those wolves? So I'm assuming you're just going to kill one. And then I'm past the turn after that.
At the end of your turn, I'm going to wretchedly confluence.
Going to return some creatures?
New.
Okay, because you can't choose Oracle and we'll die. Cause that's,
you can kill that wolf, though. It's got 2 damage on it.
Oh, man. I'm not going to do that. I'm going to draw 3 cards and lose 3 life.
Okay.
Oh, so you are at 21 after all.
Yeah, that's what I said earlier.
I afforded Wes that extra 3 life justice. Lose it later.
And then draw 1, draw 2.
Losing 1 life to draw some 3 cards is definitely not...
But the best part it is...
Not a squandering of resources.
I have a really big surprise for just Jeremy.
Oh, boy.
That was my favorite kind of surprises.
All right, before I start my turn, I want to point something out to all the kids at home.
Hey, kids.
This is still a wolf.
That's how you get your little animal to survive. You just say it's going to die.
This is still a snake,
and
too.
And you accept it if it did.
They're addition.
And then in addition to? Oh, yeah. Well, that's fun.
You're playing with a... I don't know, I can't think of the phrase.
Fire?
Nope, that wasn't even it.
3 people said it.
Nope, playing with house money when you think your planeswalker is going to die.
Right. Yeah. I was like, we don't know where you're getting at, but the common phrase is playing with fire. No, he's a non-believer.
You're doing a little bit of both.
Later, when we get done, he's jumping off a bridge. He's, you know, slowly dying anyway. Why not?
All right, now I'm actually going to damnation.
Well, sure.
Yeah.
All right.
Ruin everybody's fault.
Now, what you taking? Give me that oracle back.
You want any of these?
Why don't you take some?
Nah.
You get a Huntmaster that fails. You go Master the Wild Hunt?
Nah.
This one's
you don't want any of these?
None of them are XL.
Yeah, they're all just go to the
graveyard. Just go to the graveyard. I was like, they're not XL.
No, but that one was his. And this, you were handing.
I like these.
This is a green creature.
Yeah, I know.
They're doing just fine over
really
here.
Trying to hold this because I knew it was the damnation, but it's just such a good card.
And then.
Thank you.
One.
Call of the Grave stays alive.
4, 5, 6.
You're welcome. I did it for you, 7. Steven.
Ooh, spiders. Spotted.
Where are my spiders?
Spiders.
That's the phrase,
I'm still
right?
Delirious.
So crazy.
I am so crazy. And then I'm going to Ophithopter.
I'm going to have to not do anything about it.
Sounds like Liliana's about to die.
No, it's 3, not.
4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Oh, they all have reach.
Super not. I can
are they spinning webs?
I can never attack West.
They're spinning webs.
If only there was a way to make him attack things.
I got bad news for you, Arachnoid.
How much mana you got?
You done?
I am definitely done.
No, Wes, are you done?
I'm done, yes.
Okay.
How much mana do I have?
Now I'm talking to this guy with the 2 soul rings.
The 2 soul rings and the
I get
lands
that
here. And,
you, yeah, you get
and
it.
The Emrakul.
I didn't have great
betrayal. You're going to get it.
What?
You're going to get it.
What did I do?
All right. I'm going to draw. That was not bad.
I think he might have 15.
He's got enough mana to cast Emrakul.
Temple of the False God.
Another one?
This doesn't matter.
No, I'm tapping it.
This is so ridiculous.
Voltaic key, and I'm going to pay 2 to play another Voltaic key.
I'm just saying that Oracle, you're not even using it, and you won't give it back to me.
Yes, it's been spite the last 2 turns, I'll be honest.
He could have used a Hunt Master, he just didn't want to do it. It's just a free wolf and 2
Okay, so I have an artifact, creature, and land, which is roughly the best that my deck can possibly do.
Did it make colorless enchantments? Yeah, they do.
They don't make colorless enchantments, no.
I wish Imprisoned on the Moon was colorless.
Okay, so I can make 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Use 2 to go to 10, make 14.
I'm going to need you to recount that.
Why? You think I was wrong?
No, just go.
Just because he wants to delay it as long as possible.
8, 9, 10, 11, 12. That's correct.
He wants to stop 14? The pain from coming.
That's correct. You're correct. Yeah.
Okay.
Just a little fact-checking mission, you know? Yeah. I did that.
I understand.
You know that you can kill us with Hedron Matrix Emrakul the Promisean.
That's not...
He could kill all of us and get a point each time he does it.
Yeah, that's gross.
I do think it's time before I bite the dust to...
Before he bites the dust, he says to at least 2 players with 0 creatures on board.
Well, that makes my choice easy now, doesn't it?
Yeah.
All right.
He also has 7 cards in his hand. He discarded a card.
Okay. It's just spiders, Justin. You don't even like spiders.
That's probably why.
You don't want to mess with them.
All right, so this is going to give me 6 mana. Tapping these, I'll untap these 2. So 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
All right, let's... I want to talk about something really quick. before anything crazy happens.
With the gun to my head, I want to tell you about this.
Now listen.
Now, let's say...
You remember when you killed my Thopter? I remember.
Let's say you die before my next turn. What happens then?
Well, I don't think that's going to happen.
Okay, well, go.
That's fine. Can't take it if he's not in the game. Yeah. What do you mean?
Yeah, that. If that was your question, yes, he cannot take your turn when he's out of the game.
I'm promising.
And as the rules change, you can't look at my sideboard either.
You're absolutely right. I can't. I'm promising to take control of Wes's turn.
That was flying trample protection.
Pretty
from
pathetic
instance.
Sound. It was a good pathetic sound.
In case you guys didn't know what it did,
flying trample haste.
Protection from instance.
Haste? Protection from instance. Yeah.
It does not have haste. Oh, I don't. I wish.
Can you make it into a werewolf and take these?
No.
Maybe, but you can't do it at instant speed.
No. I don't think that there's anything else that I want to do. So I'm just going to
sacrifice.
I'm going to pass the turn. Hey, I'm going to maintain that might happen.
I have one request while you're taking my turn. While you're taking my turn, can you personally make an Oracle Maldaya so it almost feel like I have one?
We'll see.
That's a good one.
Is it?
Are we looking over here?
I don't know how this works, and that's kind of a problem.
Ear Muffet, guys. He's got to ask Troy a question.
La, 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 just la, la.
Do your worst.
Don't do your worst.
Don't do my worst.
Do whatever you want to do.
What do you have in your graveyard?
Probably quite a few werewolves and wolves.
Yeah, that's cool.
Maybe a couple humans. I don't know.
Yeah, that's cool. What do you have in your
graveyard? Get that Door of Destinies back if you really want
to. I've got an arachnoid.
Give me your graveyard.
You're asking me.
I don't want to hear it. Give me an arachnoid.
That's not how I sound.
I think you should have told him the flavor text and all of them and have him guess.
I might have got one.
Unhinged draft.
He has eaten about spiders in his graveyard.
I have.
Well,
constructed all stars.
It used to be something else.
And then also some, you know, limited other fodder. Cards. Some other cards, yeah.
I'm going to cast
Oh, boy.
Living death.
Oh, you weren't threatened by what was in my graveyard?
No, I wasn't.
Okay, Jeremy, really. Do you have any effects?
I untap this Orn Reef.
Wait a minute. No. I'm going to sacrifice my Ishkanah.
To what?
Please?
Nope.
Don't think you're going to.
So you don't have any effects?
Nope.
Oh, I do. I'm going to sacrifice Emrakul, the Promised End. To my graveyard.
How?
With Mirror and the Moaning Well on my three mana.
Oh, no.
So I'm going to gain 13, go to 31.
Oh, jeez.
Does it not shuffle in?
Nah, it just lays there.
It's not really? Like the old Titans. Yeah. No.
There's no avatar effect on there? What are you doing, wizards?
They knew what they were doing.
Well, you have to cast it to get the extra turn, right?
Yeah, but I still have Wes's.
Yeah, no, I'm saying, but you have to cast it.
To get I have to cast it.
Yeah.
Mm. Yeah.
I'm going to get these three zombies back.
I'm going to get...
Thopters, you didn't do that great of a job, but it was okay.
That's what I'm doing. Yeah.
So how much negative is my hangerback walker going to get?
Enough. It doesn't matter.
Look at this one lives. I get this trigger still, too, right? I get two life.
Sure, you get the trigger.
What's going to live?
This is a 4-4.
The Hunt Master. Or Master of the Hunt.
Right? Why is it a 4-4?
Because of that.
I don't understand.
It's a... Well, no, this is a wolf and werewolf, and this is a human.
Oh, none of it lives.
Yeah,
well, even the token doesn't
live. So everything that was in play goes to the graveyard, right?
Yeah, and everything essentially that has three or less toughness that's not a zombie is going to...
Yeah, I'm putting the Ishkanah, and I think I'm going to do that. No. I'll put it here.
Great.
Three or less toughness. Okay, yeah.
All your things are gone.
Even your 2-2 wolf, because it's going to happen before.
Well, I just was wondering if I get the
triggers,
life.
Right?
Yeah, you get the 2 life for sure.
Yeah.
32. So you get everything, and then Huntmaster lives for a second, and then when this dies,
mm-hmm. Didn't you gain 13?
Then this is going to die. I did gain 13. I'm at 31.
Well, these both die, right?
Yeah.
Because this goes away still.
Correct.
Yeah.
And then it will kill the other two.
I think we have some triggers.
And the 2-2.
To resolve.
There's
only a 3 toughness. Yeah. So we resolved Jeremy's trigger. He gained 2.
I gained 2, and I got like, I'm 32.
And I think it's going to kill this.
When Stingerflinger Spider comes into play, I get destroy target creature with flying. Do you have any creatures with flying?
Oh my gosh, I get a cast.
Yeah, look at all my creatures with flying.
Do you have any creatures with flying?
I don't.
No problem.
Do you have any creatures with
flying? I sure did. It's already gone.
All right, I'm going to leave it in play. No, it's dead. And then we got a skull.
That's when you cast, right?
Hey.
Yes.
Yeah, okay.
Who are you choosing?
So you can't cheat it.
Yeah, you.
You're choosing me?
Yeah, I'll choose you. I choose you, Stephen Green. Can we have a Pokeball fly on the screen now? Knock him in the face.
I'm just kidding. I want another land.
I'm going to get this Damnation. I was going to get the Wretched Confluence, but he's just going to cast
it. Who are you choosing?
You chose me, and I got a land.
Okay. Scry?
Yeah, no
problem. Scry bottom.
Yeah.
Show my hand cam. It's not good.
The mountain.
Basically. That's what I put on the bottom.
It was a mountain.
We assumed it was a mountain.
It was a mountain. I wish I had 2 zombies in my hand.
I wish I had any creatures in play.
I'll just cast this one.
What? Do you have any creatures?
He killed them all with his Noxious Ghoul.
Wait, didn't this is gone, right?
That's gone, yeah.
Anything with 3 toughness or less.
Oh, yeah. Bye.
Yeah. And then I will cast an Undead War Chief.
Oh, great. It's almost like that, like,
oh, and then
6th
so
or 7th turn.
All right.
Came back.
It did. Your go.
Oh, boy.
I can't wait for your turn. I'm so excited.
It makes one of us.
I'm going to wreck so much havoc.
I thought you're going to...
No. No, I'm going to wreck it.
Like, wreck it, Ralph?
Like, wreck your turn.
I'm going to wreck it. You wreak havoc.
Game trail.
No, I'm going to... Wreck it. I'm going to wreck it.
You wreak havoc.
Oh, my gosh.
Whoa there, Mr. Director. I'll repeat camera.
Shots fired.
I know. The North Carolina education system's lacking.
You can talk about your own mom, okay?
Don't talk about ours. I know. We're just joking.
Don't have enough to do.
Everyone is here is from North Carolina except
kill him.
The Cylon.
Kill him.
Michigan. Just because you weren't born in space.
That's true.
Or born at all.
No, not being born in space.
Created
is huge.
In space.
Created in space is correct.
You have a Satyr, if you so wish.
A 3/3 Satyr.
Or you can add one mana.
Oh, for each gosh. Creature.
Not just a 3. Does it? Was it put in?
It's not a 3/3.
No, it's not. It's
a 3/2 Satyr if it's attacking.
If it attacks, yeah.
Yeah, if I'm attacking.
Or if it just comes into play.
Ooh, a 4/3 Satyr.
Wow. Is your mind blown yet?
Choices.
So many choices.
Of all the choices, you had that one, and that was the one you chose. Sounds like a song.
Aren't you glad I let you gain that much life?
Aren't you glad I have an arachnoid stinger fling spider into play?
You're not for long.
Well, I mean, he would have just killed me, so yes.
What does this do? Block his own half flying?
It has haste, so it's going to attack Justin because he doesn't have...
For 4?
Yeah, anything right
27.
Now. And he gained a whole bunch of life.
I did.
27. Go ahead.
Oh, yeah, I would love to.
Sacrifice creature.
You don't have. You're not empty-handed.
Sacrifice
no,
creature.
No, jazz hands.
No, upkeep. I need to see his hand. Come on. Oh boy. Oh, this is a great hand. You know how good this hand is.
Is it so good?
It's so good.
Hey, can we sack a creature now?
Does it make you want to sing "Sweet Caroline"?
Wait.
Sweet
not my
Caroline.
Arachnoid.
Oh, oh, oh.
All right, I'm going to draw.
I would sing with you normally, but I'm very depressed right now.
Well, you're not taking
it's
your
not
turn.
Even over yet. I don't know why you didn't Valrai Stronghold some terrible card on top of it.
Because I was tapped out.
I wanted to see what I could get. Put the top two cards of your graveyard, of your library into your graveyard, then I could return a creature card from your graveyard to your hand.
Oh, does that kill my Liliana?
It sure did.
You were right all along.
Two. What will I choose? It's going to be this Skullwinder so I can get a card back myself.
And you're going to fail to find.
That's great.
He's going to start doing
that's
this
not
to
true.
Us.
I'm just going to get Harrow.
And then fail to find.
Oh, no. I'm just going to sack that Volrath Stronghold.
Or he's maybe going to start doing this to us every turn.
Yeah. Okay.
We laugh now, but it's going to hurt later.
Yes.
This is going to be here much longer. So we're going to choose this. You're going to choose Harrow, because that was a good card to choose. You're also going to select me, because you're a sweetheart, and I'm going to choose probably Relic of Progenitus. Yeah. Yeah, that's a good one. I'm going to choose Relic of Progenitus. Okay. Let's see here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh, I haven't cast anything yet.
Yeah.
Oh, no, I cast this thing. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. That's interesting. So, I think the first thing that I'm going to do
is pass?
Nope.
Oh.
Is cast my own living death, a.k.a. Wes.
Jeez.
I will admit, that Penumbra Spider is going to be pretty good. This is going to come back and then die immediately.
I gain 2.
34.
And I get a wolf.
Oh! Is that it?
Yeah. These are in play.
Graveyard's not very good, is it?
I wouldn't lie to you about these things.
Don't think he's harrowing now.
No, I'm going to cast Damnation.
Oh, boy.
I already knew that was happening.
Yeah.
You do get a Penumbra.
It's a black spider, right?
Yeah.
2/4.
Yeah.
Let's go ahead and return all these creatures back to the graveyard again.
You do conveniently have 8 mana.
You mean 8 what?
8 cards. Yeah, not okay. Mana. Okay. You're going to have this one. I think you probably have that one. You can have this good. One. This one seems extra good. I choose you discard Whip of Erebos.
Hmm.
All right.
That's pretty okay.
All right. I'm done.
So now I get
now
to take
your
turn.
Hmm.
At least I got to keep my Volrath Stronghold.
You didn't keep your Volrath Stronghold.
It's always a bonus.
What will I choose to do on his next turn?
Hey, sack your spider.
No.
Yeah, sack your
no,
spider.
No, thank you.
All right, well, sack your spider.
It's gone.
All right.
For some reason, I thought the second part of that was that you skip your next turn.
Nope. They merely get one.
Yeah, they just get another one.
That's why I was like, he's going to do it to us, but it's not all bad, because after he takes one, I got to take one.
Yeah.
Unless I Shrek you real good.
Unless you put that Ugin's Nexus into play.
Yeah, but, you know.
Yeah, I've seen it. I know what it does.
You know.
Can you make him discard his Relic of Progenitus?
How many times has that Damnation been cast? Is that three? Or is that four?
I think it's three.
Three.
Death Ritual.
Well, that's going to trigger.
It will trigger. For so nine.
Two, five, nine.
Yep.
You get three.
You get three Duders.
Is this the fourth time he's cast it now?
It's the third. No, it's the third. I just changed it.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
And then I'm going to end my turn. Draw a card? Draw a card.
Okay. Hey.
Hello. Now you could at least give me my Oracle and we'll die back.
Hello.
After you don't even know what's going to happen this turn. It's going to be crazy, though.
I'm going to put a Junk Diver token and sacrifice it, Call of the Grave, and I'm going to choose Ugin's Nexus. And then I'm going to draw my card for the turn.
Does anyone have a way to destroy all artifacts? Because he would really hurt him.
Really?
Hmm. Well, you're the two playing the green decks. You clearly don't have anything.
I never thought
you came prepared.
Right now.
So he cost 15.
That's almost as much as his baby mama.
10.
I don't think you have 15 now.
No. Four. So this is 6. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13.
How many of those cards are there? The 14. Only one I can think of is the green-white one from Shadowmoor.
Well, he costs 15.
Destroy all artifacts?
15 minus 3.
Now, Wave of Viritol, there's a creature that does it. You guys, there's like two dozen ways for you to...
Sorry, I didn't metagame against his deck, Steven.
Creeping Corrosion.
Not all of us do that.
Two dozen ways.
Oh, metagame against... You mean have answers to cards in your decks?
I mean, I have ways to destroy artifacts and enchantments, not
I need more mana.
I know if you didn't go crazy with that Junk Diver.
I know that seems crazy.
Yeah, you went crazy with the Junk Diver.
You didn't even have to do that.
You didn't have to do that.
Huh? I know.
Hey,
I really...
Hey, Parnell.
But how could I not?
You didn't even have to do that.
I didn't.
The best part is I really want Parnell to do something.
I can't do something sweet. I can't do it all, though.
I want to do something really sweet, because he has it set up to do it.
I can't do everything I want to do.
How do you know this, Steven?
Because you gave him all the cards. Emrakul the promised him.
You promised. And then you delivered. Okay, I got to just do something, though.
Well, first off, he has two Ugin's Nexuses if he wants them.
Well, they're legendary, and the other one stops the turn from being taken. So it does not that does not work, unfortunately.
Oh, darn.
I know.
It's funny how Ugin's Nexus works with this card. You know, about the lore.
Okay, so
Ugin's like, I don't really like
I'm sorry, I'm so sad for my last turn.
All right, I'm going to make six.
A whole bunch of mana?
I'm going to make six mana.
Only six?
You have a Tom Vault in your deck?
It's banned.
Really?
I'm going to take six mana and use two of it to play an Arcbound Ravager.
Don't put... Are you putting a copy in play?
No, I'm not.
Okay.
So he has one more counter. So I have four mana. I'm going to have one. I'm going to play Ugin's Nexus. Oof. And I'm going to copy it. And as a state-based effect, I'm going to have to sacrifice one of these. I'll sacrifice this one.
And so it begins.
All right.
That one we might actually have to...
Well, he's
got... No, that definitely works.
No, I just meant indicate that it's an Ugin's Nexus.
Yeah, this... Oh, don't worry. It's not going to be in play very, very long.
Especially since...
Mm-hmm.
I need more mana, so I'm going to tap for three. I'm going to play a Sculpting Steel.
Wait, so doesn't this get exiled?
And cup. No, that's only if it would be to put into a grave or prey. I said exile and take an extra turn.
Yeah, yes. That's what you just did.
Okay.
You sacrificed it.
But I can't take an extra turn.
Why not?
Okay, so because this is...
It prevents him from taking it.
All right, so I messed up.
That happens.
That's fine.
What's got him on the rules?
Take right, that, Justin.
That we should be following.
So, that's fine.
Sculpt the Steel Sculpting is now steel, a Soul Ring.
And I'm going to, yeah, I'm going to copy it, make another Soul Ring.
Sure you don't want to copy that?
I can't, I didn't cast that.
What's wrong with you? Maybe.
And then I'm going to tap 4 and put a Relic of Virginis into play and copy that. You following me, camera guy?
No. No, I'm gonna, no one's following
I'm
going
to sacrifice an artifact and sacrifice Ugin's Nexus and take an extra turn after this one. So, I still have 1 mana floating, but it's not going to really matter. Steven, I'll have you exile 2 cards. Okay. I'm going to take my next turn.
Anybody else want to go get ice cream? Well, he just plays the rest of this game.
Wait a minute, wait a minute. Don't you lose points if you take multiple extra turns?
Yeah.
Upkeep. Upkeep.
Trigger. Sacrifice creature.
I choose you. Oracle will die.
Will you? I'm going to tap 1. Untap it and tap it again for 3 mana. Make a Junk Diver. Sacrifice Junk Diver, call to the grave, return Exodus map to my hand. Alright, I'm going to draw. That was a good one. I have Ugin. Sometimes you don't need to use the expedition map.
Sometimes it just comes to you naturally.
Okay, so now I have... This is 3. 3 mana. 5, 7...
Oh, I forgot to draw a card from your last turn.
Okay.
Is it a May?
Nope. Oh, yeah, it is a May.
Alright, 5... Excuse me. 3, 5, 7... 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. So I have 17 mana. And Ugin costs...
Emrakul.
Emrakul, not Ugin.
Costs 13 again.
He costs 13 minus 2, so he costs 11.
Well...
Minus 1.
Minus 1.
Minus 2.
And then plus the 2, right?
So and then minus the 2 again.
So yeah, I have
Ugin. Oh, because I Ugin, yeah.
That's what I meant. Minus, with
I actually didn't see the second card in your graveyard.
Yep. Okay. So, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11. Nine. You know what? I think it's going to save me 2 mana. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. No, it doesn't matter. 11. All right. I'm going to cast Emrakul. Wes, I'll take Jeremy's turn this time. And then... I'm going to tap 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And play Mindslaver.
He could have played Mindslaver and copied it with a copy on the stack, sacked the original one.
Yeah. I could have done the same thing with Ugin's Nexus, and I was going to do that, but then I messed up.
I know you were.
You got a lot going on.
With the 1 extra mana, I'll play Expedition Map.
Ah, yeah, can't forget that.
Are you done?
And I'm done.
Draw card.
I've done so much.
Okay. What right, creature team. Died this turn? I'm just kidding.
Junk Diver. I'm going to lose because I don't know what's happening.
No, you're going to lose because I'm going to kill you.
That's probably a good way. Good reason. Good reason.
I applaud your efforts, sir.
Because I know what he's probably going to do on my turn.
Gisa. Two. Three.
A three.
Four.
Four.
Rooftop storm. I've had nightmares of that one from last week.
Yeah.
You're up.
I'm up.
Untap.
No sacrificey.
No creatures died your turn, right?
Draw for the turn.
No, there were no creatures.
Do I even get to know what that is?
It's a shrill howler.
Okay.
Now yes. We all.
Yeah, you do get to see. You do get to see.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's just controlling it.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know. You gonna cast the?
You gonna cast some stuff?
Jeremy, you can't do anything.
No.
What's wrong with you?
You can cast his general.
I'm gonna tap all this land.
You can cast his general and beat Wes in the head with his.
Seder
you
token.
Beat me in the head with the Seder token.
No, then Wes will draw a card. Then Wes will draw a card.
No, I'm not going to block.
Yeah.
Yeah, I am. I'm lying. I have a Call of the Grave in play. I'm definitely blocking.
Yeah. Yeah, it seems pretty bad. Well, I'm going to regenerate all werewolves you can
draw. Yeah, you're.
I'm also.
Going to draw zero cards?
Going. That's. What? No, I'm going to plus.
He's going to add zero mana.
You have zero mana.
Yep. Then you're going to cast Shamanic Revelation.
Shamanic Revelation.
For zero cards.
Yep. All right, I'm done.
All right.
That was the worst.
Yeah. Thanks.
Better luck next turn.
Your turn.
Should have taken Wes, but I was feeling mean. I was like,
your
I'm
turn.
Taking his.
Yeah, I'm just going to waste turn. Like three of.
Your turn. Hey, at least he ticked up your Xenagos for you.
I know, right?
What a swell.
Should have put a token into play. You'd have to die right now. It'd be dead from Call to the Grave. And you could have attacked yourself and blocked it with your Emrakul, the Promised End.
I don't want him to draw a card every time.
He'll forget about it.
No.
It's a May.
I remembered like a second too late. You had just untapped.
Sure, you did.
Man.
Kesk Prowler.
I like this one. This is the werewolf I like.
Wes. Oh.
Shrill Howler.
Yeah.
That you let everybody know.
Yeah, you probably are.
As long as you drain him out of the game, we can get it going.
Make a Seder.
Hey, to get the extra point, I just have to cast him four times, not cast him from the command zone four times, right?
No, you have to cast your general from
the command zone. Well, we weren't very specific about that. It was cast four times.
This is important with the Volrath's.
You definitely have to cast it from your command zone.
I need a judge's ruling. I need a choice ruling.
What do you got? You got a 2-2? Oh, you got Emrakul up. Okay.
But, I have a 2-2, though.
Yeah, well, you know.
They have haste.
He's been sacrificed. This guy has haste. He's been sacrificing all sorts of stuff.
Yeah,
you can
really
sleep it back as a blocker.
Yeah, that's probably what I'm going to do.
But not for Emrakul.
No, not for Emrakul.
Emrakul's not going to make it.
I'm going to pass then.
That doesn't reassure me in any way that Emrakul's not going to make it.
He might make it. I don't know. Nothing died, right?
I'm done. Nothing died.
All right.
Upkeep. Trigger.
Yep.
Draw.
Yep.
So this guy's going to cast 5, 6,
11.
10, 11. So I got 3 mana to play with.
Yeah.
That's not enough.
Play with it.
You know the best part about it? He gets no Morbid Trigger.
Yeah. Something else could die. You don't know.
It's true.
As I learned the hard way during the beginning of Commander Versus.
It's been a long road, Steven.
Yeah.
I've actually...
Many rules were learned.
Leave and play because...
Many more rules were forgotten.
Leave and play because of lethal damage doesn't mean you died. Why would it mean that?
I should have put that in my graveyard.
I think that's why new players sometimes struggle with Magic.
Yeah, no kidding.
Because the rules are...
Because that makes no sense.
I mean, I struggle with Magic, too. Let's be serious here.
No, you removed it for the command zone. It didn't die. I lightning bolted it. But it didn't die. Don't worry.
Parallel lives.
Parallel lives.
All right.
Doubling all them tokens.
Oh, my lord. Can you kill his tokens and kill him before you cast that general?
What?
I was trying to figure out some way to abuse Wes.
Let's not abuse me. I'm fine.
Abuse Wes with Emrakul.
I'm good. I don't need to be abused.
But we promised you. Did you notice that he has the same power and toughness as Triskaidekaphobia?
Triskaidekaphobia?
No, it's Delaphobia now.
5, 6, 7, 8.
I always thought that was cool.
Just because your friend Del.
I'm giving 13s.
I'm going to then Harrow.
Yeah, it's a very Innistrad flavorful card.
It is.
I gave that back to you. What a fool I was.
The Harrow?
Yeah. Yeah, I'm pretty sure I have 2 basics left. If not, I'd feel real silly.
That would be the greatest.
It would be really funny.
Man, I got at least one, so we're breaking even.
Couple well, if you only have oh, one, man. Two, three, yes. four, five, oh, six, seven, so eight, yeah. nine, 10, 11.
I thought
you
I
did
had
really
one
bad
more.
On the basic plan.
Yeah, I know. It's okay. Yep.
Oh, man.
It's okay.
Sack you have 20-something non-basic lands in your deck?
I mean, to be fair, that was still a good... Oh,
no, they're showing in the graveyard, too.
Oh, I was like,
yeah,
geez.
There's a lot of...
Oh, I was like, geez, that's a lot of non-basics for Black Creek deck.
You just put in a whole bunch of
I expect
colorless.
Him to have yeah. as many basics or non-basics in his deck.
I got
he
two
is
basics.
Very basic.
Yeah, two
you have 2 wastes?
I have 2 wastes. I still have enough.
I'll be honest. You don't need to wind and canyons in your deck.
I'm going to put 4/1/1 insects.
Might not in a turn Emrakul. You never know.
You could have did it just a minute ago instead of casting it. You could have waited and been like, oh, Jeremy's turn sucked. I'm going to take Wes's turn.
It's true.
It of the Horde Swarm.
Okay, what is the It of the Horde Swarm?
Whenever you cast it, you get 2/1/1 green insect tokens on the battlefield.
With and parallel lives.
With parallel lives, I would get 4. It is a 4/4 for
is
eight.
Is it spiders or just insects? Just insects?
They're just insects.
Aww.
But I can regenerate them if I need to.
Hey, remember that time Randy Bueller called that black green deck that one name?
No, I don't.
Then it's your turn.
I think we should. None of us should remember that.
Yeah, I wasn't going to say it because here's the thug. Emrakul, the me. Promised end.
She has. She's promised well, and she's going yeah. to deliver.
I really hope not.
Well, it's me or you.
Well, he has a trigger.
Yeah, I don't think he's sacrificing Emrakul to it.
He could. You don't know.
No, I do know. Yeah. He's not.
I'm not. It's true. I'm going to...
Big surprise, he's not.
I am going to... sacrifice...
an Arcbound Ravager?
Well, I'm gonna make a junk diver.
And then...
how much mana is right here?
This is 3.
Okay.
This is
yeah, okay.
I'll take key plus untap. With the trigger on the stack.
I'm really confused.
Oh, that one's on tap, sorry.
Yeah, I was like
I'm gonna tap 2 Sol Rings and I'm gonna Mindslaver Steven.
Spread the love.
Gravecrawler trigger. I'm gonna sacrifice this. Get back my slaver.
Gravecrawler trigger.
Not call of the grave. Call
something with call and grave in
call,
the name.
Something with call and grave. Let me get that back. So I have Steven's next turn. Okay, I'm gonna take my turn.
Which one? For you or for him?
My actual factual turn. So you have how big are these?
1/2s.
I need you to lose one more life.
Uh-oh.
I'll find a way, don't worry. Life will find a way.
Why would you need him to lose one more life?
Because. I think what I'm just going to do is tap 3, 4, 5, 6.
Just.
7, 8. Yeah, just.
Oh, you could have killed Wes this turn.
I think it will.
Oof.
Definitely could have, though. I see it now.
Eugene, the spirit dragon.
The spiritual dragon.
And I'm going to minus 4.
I kill, was it?
It exiles everything with every colored permanent with converted mana cost 4 or less.
Oh, exiles.
Yep.
So every girl alive costs 5.
No, it's 4.
It's 4.
Oh.
So that's everything, but yeah, it is. And then I'm going to 1, 2, 3, 4 here on Matrix. Wes?
He's got flying, right?
For 26.
26. I'm dead.
26E.
Dun, dun, dun.
All right, Steven. What's happening?
What's happening?
All right. So you're actually what's just mind, you're actually just mindslavered, right?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay.
Just cast this for me.
Nah. You've had a great turn. Good job, buddy. Go ahead, Jeremy.
Oh, boy. Let's see what happens here. Nope. That doesn't do it. I'm going to cast a card that doesn't matter. Six. Pathbreaker Ibex.
Yep.
And four.
That's a goat. That's a dangerous goat.
Danger goat now.
Yeah, and I'm done.
All right. I'm going
to
tap.
I think we have a Call to the Grave trigger.
I'm going to tap all of these. We do have a Call to the Grave trigger. I'm going to make. This is gone, also.
Yeah,
I'm going to make a junk driver. A junk diver, sacrifice it. I guess I'll return this to my hand.
I guess.
All right. Draw. Jeremy. She's coming in.
Yeah.
Steven?
Yep.
I'd like to slave you.
Mm-hmm.
Go ahead. That can almost kill that.
It can't. I need this XX.
That's true. All right. You look done.
Yep.
All right.
I'm just going to pick my cards up.
I'll sacrifice this.
Yeah, I'm just going to pick my cards up. It's fine.
Okay. She'll attack you for 26.
I thought so.
Turns out 26 was the number you need to be scared of instead of 13.
Twice 13.
Yeah.
Providence.
So
at
the
least it wasn't Triskaidekaphobia, but I do keep losing the things
so,
in release videos. Yes.
In 13?
The only problem I have with the lore of all this is they imprisoned Emrakul on the moon. So they misnamed the card because it's not Emrakul the Promised End. We never got to that
because
they imprisoned it on the moon.
Yeah, but it would have been.
I did promise.
It was our Promised End.
It should have been named Emrakul the Almost Promised End.
It was Nahiri's.
Almost Promised End, but kind of got left on the moon somewhere.
It was Nahiri's Promise to End. And Innistrad.
Did you have Imprisoned by the Moon in your deck?
No.
Well.
No, that would have helped.
Now, Steven?
I don't like giving people colorless lands.
Yep.
It wouldn't even help. You just exile it and cast it.
So?
It's
still in play.
No. It's exiled.
No, it doesn't.
No, it doesn't.
I thought it exiled it.
It just turns it into a waste.
Maybe I should have played it.
Yeah, probably.
It's I'm like a Blue Ring.
Song of the Dryads? It's the same thing.
It turns it into a forest.
I thought it kind of Oblivion Ring, but it does turn it into a forest, yeah.
Yeah.
It turns it into a waste, yeah.
So
wait. Emrakul's the moon now?
No. She's floating around. She's like hugging the moon.
And she's just card is literally named Imprisoned in the Moon.
I don't understand.
Is it on the moon or in the moon?
In the moon.
Then it is an Oblivion Ring.
But it's
inside the moon.
It's
okay, well, that's what the name of the card is, but that's not what it does.
We've talked about this for way too long. All right.
There's some Vorthos.
So, what did you guys think? Everyone kind of got to do exactly what their thing did. Ulrich's thing is virtually nothing.
So you can do it.
Like, it's everybody's super excited for a werewolf legend, and it came out, and it's really difficult to flip any werewolves in a four-player game.
Uh-uh. It's unless easy.
If I stop doing anything.
That's what you're supposed to do. It's easy. You just don't cast a spell in your turn, and then you flip them.
No, what you gotta do is play Yeva. So that all your werewolves now have flash.
Well, that's true. I mean, you just like set it up where you have stuff in your hand to interact with your opponents, and you don't cast anything, and you flip them.
Yeah, that's true.
I never got to activate Ishkanah's ability, but
that's not
the most
true.
It would have ever been for like
you never
four,
chose
four, five. Four was the most it would have ever been.
You never chose to activate.
Yeah, I was trying to set for like a nice like sevener or something, but.
You need there. Something. Is there an artifact that puts spiders into play?
Maybe? Does it put 2/4 spiders into play? Because I'm only interested in those.
You could have played Riptide Replicator.
Yeah.
That puts spiders into
that
play.
That does put spiders into play.
Even though I played Emrakul, Gisa and Geralf is still my favorite. I love zombies.
Yeah.
Until that damnation, you were...
Yeah, sure. Well, I took it easy on you. I played Undead Alchemist instead of just taking your life total out. I really wanted to create the maximum number of zombies.
You were the one that gave me 13 life, Steven.
I didn't give it to you.
Yeah.
Mirroring the Moaning Well did.
Moaned and you just got 13 life. It was weird. Yeah.
I agreed after I heard it for 1 second. I was like, all right, stop. You get
13 life. Eldritch Moon. So even though we didn't see Bruna and Gisela...
Yeah.
Well, they would have clearly lost to Emrakul.
Well, they would have helped Emrakul and then willingly laid down for salvation of the promised end.
I just want to say the picture of Brisella
unsettling.
Is unsettling, and it looks like it's straight out of the movie Hellraiser.
I was actually surprised that they did that for Magic Art. I was like, that's not very.
It's pretty.
Do you know what my least favorite thing on the whole thing is?
Yes.
What is it?
No, I'm just all of it.
Oh. My least favorite thing
is that it's in two cards.
The face coming off of the other face.
It's Bruna's face, which I believe is on the right side, has two sets of teeth. Really don't like that. It's super.
It's got two chompers on her. We can't have that.
Really, it's just
so creepy. Like a real set and a false set.
It just creeps me
out.
That
was like a merge that went bad. Like it just.
It was they did the fusion dance and they were off.
Like
yeah, because that rat Farm monster thing looks cool. It's like a zombie with rats all over it. It's a rat monster.
You're talking about chittering hoes?
Yeah, it's a rat monster.
Yeah. Oh man,
I still like the town, the Hanawar. I'm just a bunch of buildings that rose
up. I like
up
that
and started...
one, Hanawar, the writhing township.
Yeah,
writhing's such a gross word.
Yeah,
almost as gross as Emrakul.
Almost as gross as wrecking havoc.
Not cry. I did. I wrecked it. I wrecked it good.
Yeah.
All right, guys. Well, we hope you enjoyed our Eldritch Moon theme video. And if you like the fact that we allowed you to vote for stuff, like instead of just saying, hey, say something in the comments, but actually put up a poll for you to vote in, let us know how you felt about that. That's certainly something we can do in the future and even different stuff like that. You know, We're still moving right along in season. This is season 4, right? Yep. I had so many, I guess, like I lose count. And we're at a very special level. We're getting close to a very special level with our subscribers. So as Jeremy said last time,
where once we get to 100,000 subscribers, there might be something going on.
So. If you're on YouTube, and almost all of you are, make sure to subscribe. You really, really want to, I promise. You really want to subscribe. While you're at it, you also want to like this video 7,000 times. Get your friends. Look, if like the new Ghostbusters movie can have like 900,000 dislikes, we can have like 7,000 likes. If they're
is it that bad?
No, it's probably, the trailer.
Oh,
okay.
I was gonna say, it's probably actually not that bad. There's just a lot of haters out there.
But if there's that many, like, 7,000?
Yeah.
And those are likes. Those are way easier to give out than dislikes.
Depends on the video.
And after you do that, make sure you comment and tell us what you think. I know I kind of went ham a little bit there at the end.
That's similar. Close to what it's supposed to do.
Yeah. But I told you guys in the beginning of the video, it was a finite amount of fun.
You did have almost all of it.
You took 1, 2, 3, 4 extra turns?
5. He took an extra turn himself.
Well, four of our turns.
Four bonus.
Yeah. Plus a bonus turn from him. That counts.
hey, well, you know, I promised the end and it came. Like, I don't know what you want me to do. So Emrakul's still pretty good. You know, I would normally say, like, you know, final thoughts from the losers, but, like, God, how many times can I say it?
Oof. Wow.
How many times, Steven? So, but seriously, if you guys have any final thoughts, since you are the losers, I will say it one more time. It doesn't get as old as I'm making it sound. It really is great.
I had fun. I enjoyed the deck.
Spiders? Yeah.
I think the werewolves are cool. Like, slightly different build would have definitely improved it quite a bit.
They should be three creature types on this. Human, wizard, zombie.
Zombie, yeah.
I mean,
we kind of look like zombies to begin with.
Well, Ghoulcaller Gisa is a zombie, right?
No.
In the commander, she's not?
Human, okay. Human wizard.
Okay, maybe they're still alive.
Also.
Yeah, he's human definitely. Wizards, and they're human wizards. We had four tribes here. You know, we had zombies, werewolves, spiders, and extra turns.
Eldrazi. We'll just call it Eldrazi.
We only needed one. So, for Westwise, for Jeremy Knoll, for Stephen Green, I'm Justin Parnell, and we'll see you guys next week. Hey guys, Justin Parnell, Stephen Green, I caught you that time, Jeremy Knoll Westwise. We're coming to you after our Eldritch Moon themed Commander Versus episode. So today we're going to be jumping ahead a little bit into next week. Normally, we do one or two random episodes per season. Most of the time, this is us making a deck, like us, the players or the directors making a deck. But instead of doing that, we're actually going to be using a very cool community tool that a lot of us use very frequently to randomly build our decks for us. And that tool is EDH Rec.
Never heard of it.
Liar. I know that's not true.
I use it almost every week.
Almost every week.
EDH Rec is a website that allows you to search by commander, and it will show you kind of like an aggregate for a lot of decks that are submitted on Tapped Out and Deck Stats. And it kind of just combines those and gives you a good list. So if you're like, if you're trying to build a general, this gives you a really good jumping off point, or reminds you of cards that you might be missing if you're building something. This is legitimately something that we use like every. I personally use it every. I'm not gonna speak for these guys, but I think I use it
every week.
Yeah, I do too. I do too.
Not gonna lie, I don't use it, but I don't use very many tools to create.
Well, you're gonna be using it today.
Yeah.
You are definitely gonna be.
And using that is why it's gonna give you the red general.
That's right.
Yeah. Well, I use cards. I just have a lot of card knowledge. Is pretty much what I was.
So EDH Rec.
I remember a time when you didn't know.
So EDH Rec just relaunched their site with a brand new interface, which is very cool. I'm actually just starting to use it. I think when we're filming this, it was pretty recent, so I haven't like got into all the new features yet, but it seems very good. It's nice and clean, and they have not replaced one feature, which we're going to be using today, which is the random feature. So what we're going to be doing is we are going to be shuffling up these cards, which are going to have one of each of our faces on them. We're going to pull a card out, and then I'm going to click the random button. And we're going to assign Steven the random red general that comes up.
Great. Maybe let's it won't put it. Mountains on my deck.
I can't wait.
When we go to the random, there is an option on there to generate an aggregate deck list for that general. So that's the deck list we're going to be using. We're not going to click on that this time, but we're just going to go and print it off afterwards, and it's going to be in next week's video, so it's going to be the exact deck list that it gives us. We're not going to change anything.
You'll know the general, but not the deck.
You know the general, but not the deck. But you can go and check it out because you have a week, and you can see the exact deck we're going to play. That's exactly how it's going to work. So, without further ado.
Wait. So, it doesn't change? So, like, if you hit random, and then later Jeremy goes and hit randoms, it'll give you the same deck and will give you a different random deck?
No. It's an aggregate deck.
So it's the same thing when you hit random. Okay.
You hit random and you get a different commander.
General. Yeah. But if you chose that general, you'd get that deck. Okay.
Now, the aggregate may change, but we're not really going to change the deck. Whatever we get today, we're going to make sure that that is the case.
Another great thing about this one is if you're uncertain and you just have a really favorite card that you want to put in a deck, you can search by card. It doesn't necessarily have to be a commander.
And you can find out where that card goes.
It'll give you like the top suggested commanders.
I can actually tell you everything about that with Cryptic Command, because I've done it.
Yeah. You can actually go super deep into this website. Like, we could sit here and talk about these features for 30 minutes, but
you'll just go there and play with
it. It's really best to,
just go check it out.
So, without further ado,
I can't wait.
The first person is, Wes, tell me when to stop.
Stop. What's the clue?
That's me. It's me. All right. So,
let's take you out of the mix first.
My random general is going to be.
Yes, he got a red, mono red. Come on, Pit Fighter.
Come on, Pit Fighter. Yes. This was meant for Steven. You were next. You told me to stop a little too soon.
So close.
Okay, so I will be playing.
Four mono reds?
Oh, I'll be playing Cabal Pit Fighter next week. All right.
Well, I did a good job.
Steven, you want to tell me when to stop?
Stop.
Oh, it's Steven.
Ooh.
All right, Steven.
Come on, back-to-back red. Come on, back-to-back red.
All right,
no Steven. No whammy.
You are going to be playing
red
Munda
general.
Ambush Leader. Well,
that's a little rally action.
Yeah, it's a little allies. Okay.
Interesting.
Down to two.
I'm just going to get some, like,
Jeremy, go ahead.
Random
Jeremy,
terrible.
Tell me when to stop.
Stop.
It's me. Come on, Blue. All right. Come on, Blue.
All right, no blue.
No blue.
Come on, Teferi.
You don't
want black.
Tulsimir Wolfblood.
That's okay.
You got Lord Doji.
That's okay. I'll take Doges.
All right, tell me when to stop. I'll stop. Okay, this is Jeremy.
Jeremy,
what
show
are we
play.
Do here? Come on, red.
Let's get some nature versus nurture.
Where's
here.
Black? We haven't had black yet. Yeah, come on, black. Time at the Murder King.
Time at the Murder King.
We know he's good.
Yeah.
Right, Wes?
He can do.
So to recap, we have Kamal Pit Fighter for me, Munda Ambush Leader for Steven, Tulsimir Wolfblood for Wes.
Oh, I'm picking up this W.
And Time at the Murder King for Jeremy.
He's gonna murder all of you. That's how it works.
All right, guys. So we'll sign off for today. Justin Parnell, Steven Green, Westwise, Jeremy Knoll, and we will see you guys next week with these random decks.